receive my content and stream health. Why is my stream health like that? Yeah, that, what does that mean? Okay, viewers may be experiencing minor issues. Why? What on earth would you be experiencing issues? I don't bloody know. Oh, bugger it, we'll just roll with it. Let's see what we got in the chat at the moment. The chat rather. Let's see, we got Liam's layout. What's another new one I've seen? Hero Lava. Intercity 2525. I'm not quite sure that one rings a bell. Ah, there's the Victorian rail Gunzel. The Stevenson's Rocket 2019. So yeah, in this stream, I thought I'd do something a little bit different. I thought I'd have a look at the like a minimum, absolute minimum, sort of like at least one workshop route. And if I transition over, there's another new one. I'm not quite sure how to pronounce your full name correctly, so if you don't mind, I'm just going to call you Nico. Let's just say hi. That's another new one. This, oh my god, Nico. Nico is. Nico is well on me. Let's go bowling. Right, so yeah, if I transition over, if OBS is ever going to pick it up. I'm from Denmark. Oh, there's Gamage, Charlie Gamage. I'm right, Charlie, just a bit worn down, really. But yeah, in this stream, I thought I'd have a look at least one, a couple of workshop routes. Well, at least one of them, anyway. It all depends how well my how TS is going to be playing, and considering the fact the amount of crap that I had over the weekend, it also was depends upon my internet strength as well. So, whenever we'll be having a look at this one. There's something I want to do, first of all, and I'm not quite sure if it's a setting in OBS. Oh, where is it? Ah, it's this. Can anybody see it now? Yeah, there we are. Right, you can see my mouse cursor for once. Right, so the one we're having a look at is this one here, the Norren Valley Line. I've never seen this before, and according to Steam, it was uploaded on the 12th of April, so I'm a month late to the party when seeing this route. But going by the looks of this route, so far as it is at the moment, it actually looks rather promising. It doesn't look like it's that heavily intensive, sort of like a scenery, which is a big plus for me because it means I might be able to actually run something for once. So if that is one thing I do have a gripe about the workshop routes, is that they only come with a quick drive. There's no free run scenarios to sort of start up that, like, each, like, one at one end of the line, one at another end of the line, and then one in the middle sort of thing. Or if it's like what I've seen in the pictures of them on the Steam Workshop, which I should have provided a link in the description to this stream, to the actual link of this workshop route, so you, those of you watching can actually have a go at it yourself as well, providing you've got the DLCs. It's one thing I wish that the developers actually provided is multiple free roam scenarios where you've got one at one end, one at the other, so at the both terminuses, depending on how many terminuses there are, and then sort of like one sort of like in the middle, whether it be like a junction or something like that. I wish they sort of like provide that, because I guarantee you, if I do a new scenario here, but I haven't got a I haven't really got a clue what the names are, so I'm literally just going to be calling it like FR colon as I normally do. Come on. We need a whole new game of this. We need a whole new game. And I'm not talking about TSW either. That's just a pile of rubbish and everybody knows it. Because in fact, they can't even implement Steam in the game nor keep their promise about, oh, it's going to have multiplayer. Neither of which are ever going to come. We all know it. It's, oh. Why have I got a shield and okay, I was about to say, hold on a second, how on earth is this user implemented like their own sort of like set location? So I'm just gonna do root origin for now and go FR colon just for now and then just do create and see where the hell it lands up. But whilst that is loading, depending on how long it takes, I am gonna read a little brief description about this. Just so that those that haven't got TSM at the moment know about it. Have a quick look at the stream first. Railway Productions 2210. Not seen that one either. Not seen that user. Tiana. Oh, it's Tiana again. Hello. It's based off of the old Barlett and Bournemouth one. Oh, do beg your pardon about the burp. I had a bit of a packet of crisps. That was the only thing I've had for breakfast. One of my favourite railways. Ooh. So yeah. So this is what it says in the description of this route on the Steam Workshop page, and believe me, it is long. It is long, this description, and I mean hell of a long. I'm only going to be reading a small bit of it. The Norham Valley Line is a fictional main line running approximately 30 miles between the towns of Marshampton and Wessenden. They're bloody tongue twisters in itself, especially if you're drunk. Good God. The line is set in the mid-50s to mid-60s, somewhere on the joint Midland and Western regions. It is served mostly by steam locos. On the Western region and Midland regions, though diesels and locos from other regions are often seen on the line. Well, we all know what we're going to do about diesels. Never going to appear. They're never going to appear on my streams. Unless I'm bribed, of course, with money. Super chat. The landscape is that of the old Barlow to Bournemouth line, and the route itself roughly follows the path of the long lost route. The hilly nature of the original route makes this route a major challenge, even for expert drivers, as the line changes from long flat stretches to punishingly steep grades. The route also showcases several features, including 14 stations, two branch lines, good facilities, working TPO apparatus, working water troughs, and more. This route has been in development for over 3 years. God, and I thought me trying to bring a trains route into TS was bad enough, and that's hitting about 5 years, 6 years now, and is still somewhat a work in progress. The line is complete to a good standard and is scenic throughout, but still requires details, adding in places to improve it further. I'm aware that some of the signals are glitchy and show permanent red aspects, and I'm working to fix this issue. Oh, this person's actually doing more than DTG ever does, so that's a plus. There's still work fine in scenarios. I think that's a bit of a grammar issue in there. I think there might need to be reworded slightly. In scenarios. They still work fine in scenarios. Okay, sorry, I was reading that wrong. And cause no issue to player or AI services. So I'm happy to release it as it currently stands. If you find any errors or issues, please let me know. I'm planning to making regular updates to the route, so feedback for changes is very helpful. Yeah, again, doing more than DTG ever does. The route, starting at Marshampton, a small coastal city famous for its fishing and industrial dockyards. Well, I can sense if there was any diesels, I can sense an 07 in red going yarr somewhere. The line heads south through the station and factory at Farlin Sands before reaching Castlebridge. Castlebridge is a small fishing town which after the war became a tourist hotspot during the summer months. That sounds very, very, very prototypical. After leaving Castlebridge, the line makes a sharp turn to the east before splitting... between the Norham Valley Line and the Western Coastway Line. The Western Coastway Line takes you over the famous Norham Estuary Bridge, which passes by Alderstone Castle before plunging into the mountains and heading south to heading southwards along the coast. It really does sound promising. Let's have a quick look at the chat just so I can have a quick breather. Cam's in. I'm surprised we're even watching, considering the fact you're meant to be working. Someone say fishing. Yes, someone say fishing. Charlie Gamage. If it's a large and steep incline, I'll take the S160. No, I'm not going to. I've got something else in mind. Tiana, what train route are you trying to bring over? Right, so in response to Tiana there, one of the routes, well, a train's route that I'm trying to bring into effect, I'm not quite sure whether anyone in the chat is even old enough to even remember this route, considering the fact how old this route is, because this was back in like trains 2004, 2006 sort of era. This is how long ago it is, so it's damn well nearly 14, 15 years old plus this route. But a train's route I'm trying to bring into TS, which I'm having such an arse in doing, because not only am I trying to recreate it almost, not absolutely spot on, because I'll be throwing sort of like my own sort of like little sort of like hints and flavors here and there to sort of like up it a little bit, and to sort of like try and make it sort of like my own sort of ever so slight, I mean ever so slight little spin-off of it. But I'm also trying to make it third-party asset free, because my goal with the route is to actually make my very first workshop route. This, and the name of the route in question, the train route I'm trying to bring into Railworks, is called Bradnop and Kingston Railway. That's the route I'm trying to bring in, and it's, I'm having such an arse in doing it, because I just, you know, for me, although I'll accept sort of like the feedback on the comments if and when it does eventually drop, but at the same time I want it to be as spot on as I can, and to the point where I'm actually happy with it, rather than releasing it and then just keep updating it time after time after time after time, and especially trying to find out like glitches, etc. So I want to make sure that everything's sort of like ironed out, and if I did need to implement anything, like I need to move a tree back or something like that, it'll only be a small little update after, you know, its general release sort of thing. I only want the updates to be minor after it's released, rather than just releasing it and just everything's gone to hell. So it looks like, because I've been looking at the Steam too much, it looks like we've been actually loaded into the route. But let's have a look. That's another new one as well. Model Train Fan 102. Not seen you before either. I'm Hearty, the Dachshund is Lee place to be. So yeah, in terms of the grade, hey, what's that? What are you saying, Charlie Gamage? Why does the drive icon look like a giant egg trying to be a spy? No idea. But let's have a look. In terms of the grades, where does it stay? I just want to have a quick look to see how steep these grades are. Here we go. This is sort of like roughly about a third of the way down in the description of the actual route itself. Islesborough. That's the name of a bloody Sodor station, isn't it? Islesborough, I swear it is. Islesborough also happens to be at the bottom of the infamous Creston Bank. An eight mile climb, mostly of 1 in 50. Gulp. So, right, okay, so now that we know what we're facing, actually, where are we? I haven't got a bloody clue where we are. We're at, okay, so we're at Wessenden. That's one of the terminuses, isn't it? Oh, near enough, though. But bloody hell, that's a, I'll tell you what, that's a fair old stretch of a route. Look at that. I'll tell you what, that is a fair old trek. That is a fair old trek. Here at Lava, you should drive a Blue King on the line. Hayden, does anyone know about increasing virtual memory to counteract the out of memory areas in train sim? There is, oh god, there was something that Micah Smokebox linked me a while ago. It's basically an application where it basically, you load it up and you basically tell it which game you want to sort of like either boost or reduce the memory of it. Ben does Minecraft, take a J21. Ben, you know me all too well, because you know the because you know damn well that I like the J21 speed chuff sounds at 25 miles an hour. You know how much I like the J21 chuff speeds at Heritage Line speed, because it's got such a gorgeous little beat. Islesborough is where the miniature engines live. I thought so. Do you know, just confirm me on that. I thought Islesborough was a reference. Phoenix Foundry. That's a, I'll tell you what, I'm spotting a load of new people I've never seen before. Hollow people. Golden Heart, Weaselton. I know where you're trying to go with that one, Golden Heart, if you're trying to implement what I think you're trying to implement. Weaselton, no, it's Westleton. I know Zootopia. I've seen Zootopia. It's actually one of my favourite films, actually. I do like Zootopia. I know where you're trying to go with that, Golden Heart. We were there at Weaselton. But is there anything further up? Oh, there's Leavenden Goods. But oh, there's a station there, is there? There is. There is a station there. Okay, so what we'll do then? I'll drag that up. Nope. Go on. There we are. Drag that up, and I'm going to enable the old TS2014 one. Consider if I can actually click and drag on these buggers much better. So, the line goes that way. Okay, and where's my... Right, there's my marker. I wish there was a cut and paste feature you can do with these icons so you don't have to drag it all around the blooming place. Well, Frozen and Zootopia. That is true, because Frozen had a character called Wesselton, while Zootopia sort of like referenced that and took the mickey out of it when the Weasel actually said, I can't remember the character's bloody name, but he corrected Officer Hobbs because she said Wesselton. And he goes, Weaselton. It's Weaselton, or something like that. They both referenced one another, which I thought was rather clever. So yes, I knew what you were getting with that one straight away. But yeah, out of the pair of them, I prefer Zootopia. To me, it's just got a much, much better storyline. That's just my opinion, though. But I just genuinely do prefer Zootopia. Oh God, this is Oh God. Oh, would you look at that? Right, so where's my? Okay, so there's the marker. So if we do J, which brings it down onto the floor, well, brings it down a little bit too much, if I'm honest. So if I then bring it here, raise it up a little bit. Where did we say we was again? That is Leavenwood. The 11 woods. Is there anything actually over to this way at all? No, there isn't. So maybe, I don't know, maybe there might be something in the future. I don't know. It would be quite interesting. It would be quite interesting. So let's name this to Leavenwood. The author, because it's a free roam scenario. I'll put me in it. Time of day, 9 o'clock. I want the AP stuff on it, so I'm gonna, in effect, have to modify the route to implement that, because you can't do that in the scenario. Oh, can you? See, I'm going to jump into the VC if you want to chat. Oh God, you'll actually be, apart from Eddie, you'll actually be one of the other only other people that'll actually win to talk to me. But I bet I can't enable the. No, I can't enable the Armstrong, weather enhancement pack in scenarios only. It has to be done by, quote unquote, editing the route. So that's what I'm gonna have to do. So I'm gonna have to pop into here. AP. I'll do both. Bugger it. I'll do track, and weather enhancement. Press F2 to save. Back. In the session maker, you can enable the AP weather in the scenario. Oh, now you tell me after I've done it, Ben. Now you tell me. So we are going to go for. Where is it? AP clear. Now I've been told mid. Where is it? I've been told mid wind is a good one. So mid wind, 9 o'clock in the morning. Leave it as summer. Let's actually see if I can actually let's see if I can launch up Discord. Oh, there we are. Yeah, we'll just pop into here. Well, that's me in one room, and coming into another room.
There we go.
There we are. We have
headphones.
And we have a bed.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, it is also stupid o'clock in the morning. I realise that.
I was just wondering, because you're like
I'm West Coast. It's currently 2:30 in the morning.
2:30 in the morning. 2:30. How does that work? Because it's not. It's only like 22 minutes past 10 in the morning. Here, so.
Or 2:20, and see whatever. Same shite.
So it's two. So it's 22 minutes past 2 in the morning for you. So you are 8 hours behind. What the hell?
Yes.
Why are you up at this time in the morning?
I fell asleep earlier and woke up around midnight.
So pretty much like everybody else on lockdown, your body clock has gone to hell.
Yes.
And I'm trying to get mine back, and so far I'm almost winning. I'm actually almost achieving something.
Yeah. Woke up, was hungry, so decided to make some bacon sandwiches.
Oh, you bastard. I've only had a packet of Walker's Quavers for breakfast, and now you're on about bacon, you bastard.
It was good.
Me want bacon. Gib the bacon. Gib.
English, please.
It did what? Did you say in Welsh, please? All right.
I said in English, please.
Well, the way you said it, it sounded like in Welsh, please.
Motherfucker.
Only once, but she was weird.
Yeah.
I'm not being creepy about that. In my very early days of dating, I did date a lass that happened to be a young mum. We were only like a year apart in age from one another, and she already had a kid from like another bloke, and I dated her for a little bit, but it just turned out to be a little bit awkward.
Just nope.
Not because of the kid, it's because of how she was reacting. She was too needy, too clingy. The kid was as sweet as anything. He was a bloody brilliant little boy. He was only a toddler, bless his heart.
Nice.
But yeah, in terms of... oh god, I'm having trouble with my bloody throat. I think those bloody Quavers are trying to kill me. God damn you, Walkers, you bastards. I'm zooming in on the game. I'm trying to do something in the chat. Someone asked about something. I'm trying to see where it was. Where was it? Model Train Fan 102. Do you have a Discord server? I do have a Discord server, but the link to it is no longer the public in the videos anymore, considering the amount of shit shows that we've had basically in the past. So now, external Discord servers are only going to be available and only available in any live streams that I make. And speaking of which, here is a Discord link to my server that has no user limit, but it has a 30-minute limit. So it expires in half an hour. So about 5 to 11, 11 o'clock, that link is going to run out.
And
there's no user limit on it. So it's not like after sort of like 5 or 10 uses it expire. It's there for half an hour. It's got no user limit. So anyone that's in the chat that hasn't been in Discord before or was in the Discord server in the old one, but then wasn't able to sort of like rejoin, there's a link to it. Let's have a look. Yeah,
I might actually end up downloading this route myself, Stephen, because it looks pretty nice.
Yeah, it does. It's, I mean, from the, I'll tell you what, one of these, from the sort of the main menu when you, before you try and load it, I don't know whether anybody saw it in the actual stream or not, but it's this workshop route is one of the very, is what I consider a rare one. And what I mean by that is that it actually has its own thumbnail template, i.e. it has its own little picture of the route. It's not like a copy and paste of sort of like it's sort of the origin basis of like a Portsmouth direct line or something like that. It doesn't have that sort of picture on it. It has its own workshop route, custom made picture for the route.
Yeah, those kinds of workshop routes are rare.
Yeah.
Nowadays.
And I'll tell you what, I don't know whether anybody is old enough to remember the sort of like the much previous versions of this game, back when it used to be sort of like Rail Simulator, Railworks, what was it, Railworks 2, it skipped 3 because then it went straight into, what was it, Train Simulator 2012 and 13, but literally when it transitioned from probably about Train Simulator 2012, maybe Train Simulator 2013, when it transitioned over to there after it finished being the name of sort of like Railworks 2, and I think it bypassed 3 because that's when it came Train Simulator. The one thing that I miss heavily, because I remember Cam saying about this between a month and maybe a year ago now, is that whenever you used to load Roots up, it actually show you sort of like its own custom template in itself. It sort of like have like a nice little background with a sort of like the white sort of like 2D map outlining of how long the route was. It had the sort of like red blobs of where the sort of like the station was, etc. And it had sort of like custom had its own sort of like small little segments of screenshots that were taken within the game using sort of like locos, as you're pointing about. I miss them. I am sick to death of showing these. Sick to death of seeing these promo pictures of like, oh, this route's out, oh, this route's out, etc. It's like, I don't want to see that.
That's why I was wondering about that. Like, is there anything like with the background changer for TS? Is there anything for that, but for the loading screens?
No. Well, actually, in all fairness, the feature for that is still within the game, but you will never be able to see it because when they sort of like see like the community screenshots and the sort of like whatever new DLC that Dovetail Games has created this time, or I say someone else has made, and they decide to publish it and go, oh yeah, we'll take 30% of your revenue, and Steam will also take 30% of another bit of revenue from there, so therefore you won't get 60% of your money from your DLC, which is a wank move. And from what someone told me, if Dovetail bypassed putting your product on Steam and sold it solely on their webpage, they take 60%. So either you have your stuff published on Steam, where DTG will take 30% of your revenue cut, and then Steam will take another 30% of your cut. So i.e. it is 60% with two organisations, quote unquote. Or you should tell DTG to upload it on their platform and their platform only, and not do it on Steam whatsoever. And they just go, okay, we'll just take 60%. We'll just basically take over half your revenue from it. It's like, are you a dickhead?
This is kind of why Victory Works top sell is mostly releasing their shites on
SSS. After the bullshit that happened to Peter Victory Works, where DTG and Steam messed up the actual recommended retail price for the Panya pack, he just basically went, right, sod this, and went over to Steam Sound Supreme to release this stuff, which is far better because it means that he will get maximum amount of profit from it. So therefore, he'll be able to sort of like get more. It will basically update his programs. You'll be able to get more resources, be able to sort of like craft things a little bit better. Might be able to bring more scripts, etc., models, etc. Because all of these programs and scripts, etc., they all cost money. You can't exactly do it on fucking peanuts, which is what DTG and Steam were basically doing to developers, which is why Bossman Games also did the same thing.
For their stuff, yeah. Speaking of Steam Sounds, from what I saw, the Stain Moors getting ready for release.
I've heard about that because someone said the Stainmore.
At least getting ready to send out to pre-order the people.
Yeah, because that's the thing. Someone said that the pre-order for the Stainmore's basically stops, and I thought, if this whole shit show of a virus lockdown wasn't implemented, I may have gotten it because I roost. Because to be fair, I'll open my I'll put my hands up to this and sort of like take back what I said, because at first I thought the Stainmore route was one a joke being the price that it was. To sort of like having sort of like more default sort of assets and anything else, but after watching Brucey's video of it, the sort of like explaining what you're actually getting, etc., I thought actually there's a hell of a lot of more custom stuff in it than I thought, and I thought for the price of it, it's actually not too bad, because it seems to be more custom assets than anything else. The one downside to the actual pack itself is the fact that with the pack it's going to. I don't know whether they've changed their mind about it or whether it's been updated since, but the only downside to the Stainmore route is the fact it's going to come with, in effect, an outdated E4. You know, the 240. It's going to come with an outdated version of that.
Chris did say if the Stainmore is popular upon release, he will take the features that he put in the E4 with the Stainmore and put them into the main pack and just update it.
So wait, hold on. There's more features in the Stainmore E4 than there is in his own base pack.
Only one, and that being the Northeastern style cab. But that's about it.
I thought he would have implemented that in his base pack anyway.
No, like that was one of the features that wasn't added. But if the Stain, he did say if the Stainmore does end up being that popular, he will update the pack he released of the E4s with the Northeastern cab.
hang on a second, this can't be right. According to Rock Trout, it's saying that it says I'm playing SnowRunner on YouTube. That can't be right.
Yeah, I saw. Yeah, it does say you're playing SnowRunner for some reason.
What?
Yeah, in the description, Steve. It's called YouTube is bullshit.
That's impossible because I've got category gaming, game train simulator. I've updated the title so it says Train Simulator 2020 Workshop Route Explorer. The game link is to TS 2020. The workshop route link is there. So why is it saying I'm playing SnowRunner? What the hell? YouTube, what the hell? Well, I say YouTube, Google, what the hell are you playing at?
Charlie saying Inga did that last stream too.
He did that last stream as well. I'm going to have a look at my own channel because I don't believe... Well, I don't disbelieve what people are saying, but I want to know what the hell is going on.
Hang on, let me check your last stream, Steven.
According to my homepage, it does say, live now, Train Simulator 2020, but the sort of Steam icon page, seems sort of Steam icon rod background, the very same one I used for my tutorial of how to activate a product on Steam, the very same image. It says Train Simulator 2020, Workshop Route Explorer 1.
So, yeah, Steve, on your last stream from a couple of days ago, it says you were playing TS.
Well, the last stream I did was Train Simulator 2020 VE Day. I wonder if it's mucking about because I'm not using the dumbass the new live stream sort of like system. Showing showrunner in the description.
Yeah, hang on, let me get your screenshot and PM it to you, Steven.
That's weird because in the description for my one, it says, obviously the normal default one, it says 1080p HD available, but it says, to pass the time, I thought we'd have a look at some workshop routes and see what I make of them in a review perspective. And then it's just got the usual like Dane's channel, Brett's channel, etc., all the rest of it. That's what in the ever-loving hell? What the hell? Is it because I'm not using the stupid new live control room and I'm using the sort of like the old classic stream view? Is that the problem?
Fuck if I know.
Is that seriously the problem? Because I've tried the new stream one a few times and it's okay to an extent, but it's actually more difficult to use than anything else. And what's more, with the old classic one, once you hit sort of like start streaming on OBS, like 15 seconds later, the old classic one would just start automatically. The new one, I kid you not, the new live stream channel thing, you hit start streaming, nearly a minute later, there's a button at the top that will then glow up and then say, go live stream. So they're all just sitting there, silent for a blood nearly a whole minute before that light at the top, the little button at the top comes visible where you can click on it and say, go live. It's dumb. It's absolute dumb. And also, you can't put in the sort of like the tags for it properly. Like when you put like in the videos, you can put like tags so you can sort of like when people are searching for stuff. If any of the tags that they, if anything they put in references the tags of the video in your video, then obviously it will come up as a search result. In the new one, there is nothing like that. You have to put the tags in after you've done the stream, which is a piss take. Whilst in the classic one, you can do it before you've even done the stream. It's the new one has its pros and cons, but it has more cons than anything else.
Yeah.
Right, let's have a look at the screenshots. Right, okay. Yeah. Okay, workshop route, that is dumb. That is dumb, because everything on my end is fine.
But for everyone else, it's fucked.
I don't understand what the hell is going on. To anyone that's still in the... still even watching the stream, I have no idea why it's doing that, because on my end I have actually tagged Train Simulator. I've actually tagged that, but I bet it's been absolutely dumb as hell. Let's see, if we do that, Seems to have been saved. All saved. Right. For the next sort of like half an hour, because obviously it'll take a while to update, but in the next half hour, people might want to refresh and then have a look at the sort of like the description thing down below and see whether it updates it, because I've just had to type it in yet again. And I want to know whether it's actually going to play ball this time.
Or if it's just going to be a massive pile of wank.
Yeah, which, to be quite honest, we can expect that from Google. Oh, wait, sorry, YouTube. No, actually, no, I'm not sorry. It is Google. Because Google own YouTube. But anyway, now. Yeah, to the matter at hand, after ranting for fuck knows how long, let's actually get a loco, let's actually get a loco down and actually drive along this damn thing.
You've been streaming for 30 minutes.
Oh, no, I've been streaming for half an hour and I've done nothing. This feels like my, what's that race I did with Eddie and Dane. I used Scotsman in America and I had the sort of the old Pullmans back then, the sort of the old electric Pullmans back then. Oh, what was that called?
The pack off of UKTS.
Oh, it was like racing. It was, oh, what was it? It was like racing to Cheyenne or something like that, wasn't it? We were talking for like 15, 20 minutes over the course of two videos and we did nothing with our engines. We were just gossiping and ranting. And we spent about 5 minutes. We spent about 5 minutes laughing and talking to Dane about how he said it took 4,489 minions just to lift one wheel up on the A4.
To be fair, Stephen, that's basically your cops to robbers races in a nutshell. When you're the fucking cops, it's just us talking for about half an hour.
Golden Heart says Google Tube. No. It's not Google Tube. It's what I call you, the viewers. It's Yougles. It's Yougles. That's what it is. It's Yougles. I've got patent pending on that name. I tell you what. If I ever make any merchandise, I would laugh my ass off if anyone actually bought and wore a T-shirt that would actually say Yougles on it.
See, I found a video. It was from 4 years ago. It was a three-part. It was in three parts on your channel. The Battle of at High Noon.
The Battle of High Noon. I bet that was it. Yeah, the one where I was on like the Cheyenne, and I was using the double tender Scotsman.
Yeah, double tender Pecor Scotsman. It was just after your 2000 sub special, and just before you decided to.
I'm just gonna type something to Goldart because I've just noticed what Goldart has just said. No. Google plus YouTube is GooTube. No. I've got something even better. I've got something even better. Goldheart. I've got something even better. You just watch this.
I'm just watching the stream chat because I've got it pulled up on my other computer. Yeah, I remember this that race, Stephen, because it was just before your review of the DTG LMS coordination. The overly shiny piece of shit.
How's that? Google plus YouTube is equals
Goob.
It's a pity that Google doesn't actually use any of that to maintain their YouTube.
Basically. Oh yeah, the DRBR 86 review. That's where the whole safety valve interrupting your thing started, I'm pretty sure, Steven.
Oh, that what was it? It was a 282 loco, wasn't it? That tank engine. That, yeah, DRBR 86, it would not shut up. It really wouldn't shut up, that engine.
And from then on, the memes just kind of evolved. On your channel. I still think, like, since you opened up the Thunder Rails cast to like people who watched your YouTube channel, i.e. me, Shiloh, and the rest of us, like all those like 3 years ago. But the two most memorable moments for me, no, three for me that I remember, the Shed Gossip sketch, behind the scenes two bloopers, behind the scenes. Hints bloopers 2 from Thunder Rails and Shiloh's hat trick of gauges.
So basically the most memorable things about Thunder Rails to you is basically the fuck ups.
Basically. No, those aren't the most memorable, those are the funniest moments. I'll say that. Some of the most memorable moments. So at least some that I remember watching, because I remember you did a race with like Top on Dipton like years ago, where you you used a Rugen of Wartime Scotsman on the, what was it, the S&D with like load 16
or something. That was a good drink pouring. people's probably thinking, what the fuck am I listening to? Is he actually taking the piss or what? In a metaphorical sense, yes, I was taking the piss.
Yes.
But physically, no, I was just pouring my 2 litre bottle of water into my pint. So, cheers.
Yes, see, I remember the shunting race you did with Mayor and the express race you did with him when Eddie decided to show his ugly face. Sorry, Eddie. Not sorry. and the tank engine race on West Island of Scotland when Dane appeared. That, and I remember the USA race that you and who was it? I think it was Eddie or Dane did on Cajon Pass when you had when you used the Berkshire. The 765.
Oh yeah.
I remember when you first released it, you did have the song Black Betty in the video.
Yeah, but then YouTube goes, oh, copyright strike. I'm like, gee, thanks, I'm gonna have to take it down, re-edit it without it, and cut that entire segment out. Gee, thanks.
I remember that the tank engine race 2 that you did with Mayron on the DR. I basically started watching that about
headed downhill, so he had the advantage, that bastard.
Yeah, I basically remember this everything from about 5 years ago, from shunting race 1 up until now.
Pour myself another drink because I've had that pint way too quick. Excuse me. That's a phrase I haven't used for many years, wasn't it? Excuse me. Because I'll tell you what, the first time I actually used that after several years was when me and Eddie was playing SnowRunner a few days ago. And Eddie said something, and I turned around and went, "Excuse me!" And he just fucking ended up pissing his nuts off.
To be honest, when does anybody not decide to piss their nuts off in this on this YouTube channel?
When I'm actually deciding to be funny for once. Let's have a look.
Speaking of which, I will always remember. Speaking of which, where is it?
J21, come to me, my little green beauty. What are you?
Where is this race that we did? Where the fuck is it?
I tell you what, out of all the Thunder Rails sort of like races I've done, probably the most memorable one to me, there's two moments, short little moments for me, that I remember the most and better than anything else I've ever remembered, was the first one was, I think it was the regional race, and I was using Blackmore, and I was using Blackmore Vale on the Granfield line.
Yeah,
I didn't realise how sharp the set of points were, and I made that fucking West Country side to side, which is my reaction. I was like, and I was so close to fucking, I sounded like a chimpanzee when it was rocking side to side like that. So that's one moment. And the other moment was when I was in an S160. It was in the snow. It was on Western Lines of Scotland. It was dark in the snow. I was with the S160 with a freight, and I think Dane was with the V2, and I had one because derailed or did something. And I was like, yeah,
the Stranraer struggle rematch.
And I was like, yeah, big Jim. But the most memorable thing about it wasn't because of me chanting going, yeah, big Jim. It was Dane's reaction. It was the way he said it that made it the most memorable. He was just like, fuck Jim.
I remember that. I go back to watch this from like 2 years ago. Oh, it was chuffing along 9 when you did the Cops and Robbers race where I joined in about very early in the stream and just said hello motherfucker. I still remember just every time I fell out my chair pissing myself laughing.
Yeah, and we would actually hear you falling out of your chair as well, and I swear one time I think you damn well nearly broke the chair as well, because you leant so far back I think the chair actually went with you, and I swear I heard one of the little like wheels or something like that, depending on what type of wheel you had, basically buggered off and went to something, because I swear to God I heard like the ding 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 like that sort of thing.
No.
Surprise! I didn't hear it at the same time. Dun dun, bing bing. No, yo.
I think that was my Xbox controller.
Now I'm trying to see. Ah, there's my J21 for the role play. So now I need to copy the config for it. copy. Yeah, after 3/4 of an hour, I'm now only starting to place down the locomotive. Organize me not.
Organized, I am not. Sensible, I can be.
Ladies and gentlemen, normality has now returned to the GWR 6029 channel.
It's Ben, that's a joke even in itself. Now what coaches do I take? Because I would like to use the AP Mark 1s, but as we know,
but
I have an issue with them.
I'd say just use the Coestrus that came with the J21.
I'll tell you what, as much as I love Pete's stuff, I'm a little bit disappointed there isn't more Coestrus types, because you just got the composite and the brake. I'm surprised there wasn't more configs, like coach styles for the Coestrus. I'm very surprised by that.
No, of course, trying to find... I think it also was a matter of, like, trying to find diagrams for them as well.
Yeah, that is a genuine point, though. It all depends upon, like, the diagrams and drawings and that. It does depend on that. Looks just stupid, because he seems to have every fucking thing on the planet.
I also remember, last year or something, when we did, chuffing along 16 on Grandfield, just some of the moments that Sky had, and just roasting Cam the entire time.
Yeah, I'd rather forget the ones with my ex in them. I'd rather
with
forget
ex, yeah.
I'd rather forget them.
Even still, some of those moments were funny. What other hilarities are there on your channel, Steve?
It wasn't Thunder Rails as such. It was sort of like a very old... I don't even think it's even available on my channel anymore. But it's... I think it's actually on... It's on Dane's, actually. It's on Dane's channel. This was going way back. We're talking like maybe 7 years ago. Right, so it was a bloody long... It's getting very close to maybe 10 years ago. This is how long ago it was. It was bloody long time ago. But it was it was back in the day when me and Dane were on Skype and we was talking to a couple of people on there. And someone said about, he's got like the big D. He went, oh my God, opportunities are right. Hold on. And I just, I was bloody creasing myself. I had pins and needles from my stomach because I was laughing so bloody hard.
I'm trying to remember the first video I actually watched of you, that via Steve. Even it was, it might have. I think it was one of your old videos from like 8 years ago. It was either the Princess Coronation video or the Princess Royal video that you had on trains. It was one of them.
Let's have a look. Northeastern Railway / Great Northern Railway non-corridor. Oh, let's have a look what these are like. Here we go. I'm sorry, what? Football saloon?
Oh, yeah, that.
Oh, God. No, just no. Football can fuck off. Not soccer, football. Shit sucks. It's fucking crap. Fucking grade A under A.
Oh yeah, that's also a point where you were when you and Maran were teaching Eddie how to actually speak English.
Oh yeah, because he was saying like things like Nissan and Jaguar and stuff. We was just like, bruh, can you even?
Bruh.
We was like, yo, blood, can you even ungrade in it, bruv?
So even to this day, I will still say Jaguar instead of Jaguar.
Yeah. it's Jaguar. Say it the English way, or you would be battered with a wet fish.
Do you guys say Hyundai or Hyundai?
I say Hyundai.
Okay.
Because there is people, for some reason, there is people that go Hyundai. It's like, what do you think it is? The fucking Pagani Hyundai. I know it's pronounced Hawaii, but people just go Hyundai. Oh god, that's a completely different colour in itself.
What is the
because I placed it. Oh, that was why I placed the GNR version, and I placed the LNR one. It's like, oh god, that's horrible. So let's place.
Yeah, the Northeastern and they're in different, slightly different colours between the Great Northern, East,
inspection.
And the Northeastern.
Oh, inspection saloon.
Ooh, inspection
Not gonna use that one. What's that? Covered
inspection time.
Covered carriage truck.
Oh yeah, that's a good one. Break or something.
Composite.
Oh yeah, Steve. I don't think if you, I don't know if you saw it on what's the name again? Golden Goldsmith Scenarios website, but they released a reskin of the Period 3 inspection saloon to look like the one on that the Seven Valley has, the one in chocolate and cream.
Oh, okay. So I think four coaches might suit the little J21 just fine, considering that's really all you can fit into this station anyway.
I'll say this about the reskin of the LMS inspection saloon. It is pretty similar to the Great Western diagram of the Great Western inspection saloon. So it fits in pretty well on the 7. The clinch field might get it at some point.
So after 50 minutes, I finally placed an engine down.
I think about 45 of the... No, not even 45, about 25 or so. No, like 30 minutes or something, was just you ranting.
Oh, hold on a second. Hold that thought, Ben. I was just reading what Goldnard says. How long does it take before I can see the other channel in the Discord? Is it timed or is there... react emoji I need to do, or am I waiting for someone to approve me? Someone needs to give you the role if you've applied to the Discord rules. So if I have a look at...
Yeah, Golden, if you would please read the readme first.
Right, so there's a Jaden B that's complied, so...
I see him. I can... Oh, nope. There you go.
There we are. Jaden B is complied.
I see Golden Heart.
Yeah, so
Golden Heart.
If Golden Heart and this other one, this Wildman 8389, pretty much going by, or someone else, Fan 102. Right, if you people read the welcome section in Discord very carefully, and also please for the love of bloody God, take the time to actually read the read me first section as well, just so that you understand what you can and can't do in the channels, etc., just so you don't run the risk of sort of like getting a warning tag, etc. Please, for that, it is so important now more than ever that you actually read, physically read what is said in welcome and in the read me first sections. It is so important you actually read them, not just look at it and go, yeah, whatever.
There's another one, Stephen. I'm GDBR Stefan.
Yeah, Stefan. Yeah, that's another one as well. So give you that. Now, something else I'm doing as well, when it comes to the Discord server, there's another tag that everyone's being, and I mean everyone is being applied to, that isn't visible in the sort of like the server list, but there is another tag that everyone's being applied to called the Yugles. And the reason for that is rather, so for example, I make an announcement, rather than tagging each individual sort of like role, if I basically enable another role with everyone else and then just use that, it will tag them all. Rather than having to list them individually, I can just give them another role, do like the at thing on that, so it lists everyone that has got it, which would be everyone. You know, it just makes things a whole lot better. But yeah, Tiana, well done, straight away, you're being approved. Straight away, Tiana.
Has Tiana joined in? Yep. Steve, did you get the manners when they were released?
Yes, I did get the Why did somebody ask that?
No, I was just wondering, because what was your initial thoughts of them?
Well, I knew that the Manners would be better than the JT ones, and I'm going to put that. I really want to put this to bloody bed because I'm so sick of it. I wish people, because I said it in the VE Day stream as well. I am so sick and tired of people really taking a shit on the Just Trains Manor now. Yes, we all know that they're sort of like they're out of date. They're not as texturally good, etc., all the rest of it. But what you have to take into consideration is the year they were made by the developer, the tools the developer would have had at the time, and what other sort of like features would have been around the locomotives at the time. Look, you've got to remember the Just Trains. You have to remember the year in which the Just Trains Manor was made, what resources and tools and programs and software they would have had at the time. And at the time when they were released, they were the only things that we had. And I'm damn well sure that we went nuts over that. And now, since Victory Works has made theirs and it's been released, everyone's now gone on their high horse about the Victory Works one and now taking an almighty shit on the Just Trains one and giving it so much disrespect, despite the fact of how many years it served us and filled a gap until you know, someone made a better version. But what I am disappointed about the Victory Works one, though, what I am a bit disappointed about is the fact that the sort of there isn't more livery variations. And what I mean by that is that we've only got the plain green Great Western one. Yes, it's sort of like prototypical. But what I mean by that is that I'm surprised he didn't include the preserved Paint and Dartmouth one. You know, what is it? Linden 2-2. Yeah, 7822 or was it 7827, something like that. It was
7822.
Yeah, but it was the one that was on the Paint and Dartmouth that was gorgeously, beautifully, fully lined. I was surprised we didn't get that because I was so looking forward to using that livery for a role play, and the fact that just wasn't included. In fact, the pack, if I'm honest, the pack has got more BR stuff in it. I was right, 7827 Linden Manor. I was right. It wasn't 7822, it was 7827, I was right. But it's,
7822 Fox code.
Yeah, but...
the Land Golf Fund.
Yeah, but I'm just upset there's more BR variations and liveries with the Victory Works Manors than there is with the Great Western ones. I mean, yeah, it's a very niche sort of thing. It's like, people may not get it, but the one thing that I have noticed, and this is what I think Chris of Caledonian Works has sort of like cottoned onto, is that fictional liveries for locomotives do make the pack just that little bit more special and do make it sell that bit better.
Hence why he's added a crap ton into some of his packs.
Mm.
And also, I think we should probably get on with the drive before we start ranting for another half an hour.
I've been going for about an hour and I've done no driving. I haven't even touched the engine. So let's put that down. Ah, that's an ordinary passenger head coat on, which is fine.
Excuse me. Also, Steve, when the stain mall comes out, I will gladly get it for you as a gift if you want.
Oh, God, as much as I appreciate if someone actually got me something as a gift and that, at the same time, I feel guilty because that means that I owe them back, i.e. I owe them money or I owe them a DLC, etc. I just feel, like I'm being sort of like people are giving me stuff as a charity because they, you know, they're sort of like, oh, you can't afford anything. Oh, you're a poor ass, etc. Let me get you something in which you have to get me something back in return, sort of thing. I feel like I constantly owe people something. It's bad enough I owe people actual money as it is, even years after I said I'd pay them back, and I still haven't been able to get it. Especially now during the shit show, it's like I'm constantly owing people stuff.
That's the thing, I don't really want anything in return for it, Steven. It's like, I honestly don't give a shit if I get anything or not. So, yeah, if I get it for you, you don't owe me shite. Charlie in chat, someone make Big Ivor that will sell well. Yeah.
Oh, actually, hold on a second. I'm going to have to restart the game. I'm terribly sorry about this. I'm going to have to restart the game.
Why? What's going on?
Because I've got a very, very horrible audio glitch. I don't know whether anybody heard it, but as I was like going along, you could hear it going, and I'm like, oh, shit. I think my sound card's fucking packing up.
Shit.
Mind you, everything on my PC's packing up. I so badly need a new one, but I don't have £3,500 for a new one. Because that is how much my new one's going to cost.
Yeah, I remember you were talking about that a while ago. Like, a while ago, I think it was like last month or something. It's like people are taking a, like you were saying about the JT, man, is people are casually taking a shit on the, King Train's, Stenia Mogul. Oh, as soon as everybody saw Boss Man's, early, work in progress shot of their Stenia Mogul.
Because that is the thing. This is the thing, right? What people are forgetting and neglecting is the fact that, you got to take in consideration when these things were made. And what resources and programs and features were made available at the time. That's what people are forgetting.
I agree with you on with the JT man, as they served as well, and the same can be said for the old Stenia Mogul. Like, I loved that thing to bits.
It's like people say, the Princess Coronation, i.e. the Duchess of Hamilton one, the only locomotive you can get from the RSC piece of crap, which is still a piece of crap, and I refuse to still fucking get it, even though someone said, there was a little update to it. I'm still not going to fucking get it. As graphically pretty as it looks, it doesn't offer anywhere near as much variety or even enjoyment as the Just Trains ones. Yes, the Just Trains ones don't have sort of like the prettiest textures compared to the RSC one, and yes, it may not have this scripting or that scripting, etc., whatever. And there's the feature where you can open and close the doors, etc. It doesn't have all those like the front of the door. It doesn't have those features. But I find the Just Trains Princess, the Streamline Coronations, i.e. the Streamline Duchesses, I find them much more enjoyable. And I actually find I believe there was two packs of them. I actually find them more enjoyable and more beneficial and value for money over the RSC one any bloody day. It's like the Just Trains A4s. Yes, the RSC A4s looked graphically pretty and their scripting.
But the JT ones gave us so much more.
But the variety that you get over the three Just Trains A4s packs, again, it's just better value for money. I mean, take this in consideration. Does the RSC A4 pack, which is only the Preserve 6, do they give you the option of having the streamlined A4 Coronation Express coaches with the beaver tail at the back? Do they?
No.
Do they give you teak coaches in different liveries? No.
Nope.
Do they give you headboards? Like, specifically different headboards? No. Nope. Do they give you different liveries pretty much nearly throughout the... almost nearly every single member, like double chimney, single chimney, and all the other liveries. No.
Absolutely not.
They're just fixed to what the engines had at the time that pack was made. Whilst the Just Trains one, they give you a variety of liveries. And I swear to God, and I'm pretty sure in the BR one, which I haven't got, I'm pretty sure they put the fucking Ultramarine, so the purple livery on the A4s. I think it was Merlin. Pretty bloody sure in their BR pack, which is the Just Trains A4 number 2 pack, I'm pretty bloody sure they put the Ultramarine / purple BR livery in there. I swear they bloody did.
Fairly certain they did. Let me check. Yeah, they put it on 6029. Which one was that? Which one was 6029?
Well, I've got a feeling that is Merlin.
6029 Woodcock.
Oh, okay, fair enough.
But yeah, I will agree with you on that. With the three JT packs, you get a lot more. Because with all three, you get everything from the Silver Streaks up until very early BR with the Ultramarine, and then up to the very end and into the Preserved era.
Yeah, because they've even, this is something that RFC never bloody did and will never ever do, unless someone like, oh, I don't know, Victory Works does it, where you can actually customize the script to have what you like, which actually wouldn't be a bad show, or even Chris at Caledonia Works for that matter, is the fact that that in the Just Trains pack, in the first one, the base Just Trains A4 pack, they gave you the option of having Mallard in preserve condition or Mallard before the record. So when she wasn't even 6 months old, so as new, as built Mallard.
Yeah. But as Chris said, he has no interest in doing like post-grouping engines.
Which is a shame, because that means that we're going to be missing out a lot of variety, especially because I know I've seen it's someone needs to sort of put it back in, because in the Discord group, I don't know whether you've seen it, but I've put in a hell of a lot more sort of like text chats. What someone needs to basically put in now, because I haven't got access to like Facebook and the rest of it. Well, I have, but I can't do it right now because Chrome's taking up so much memory.
What, his work in progress shots of the GNRA ones?
Yeah, the sort of like the blended, sort of like rendered shot of the Great Northern Railway Gresley A1 configuration, i.e., what Scotsman looked like as built when she was brand new, sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And the what is such a shame is that it looks like we're only getting that variant and that variant of sort of like the A1s only, and we're not going to get a sort of like the A3 variants or any sort of like variety and customization features or anything like that. It's such a
made
shame.
Chris did make a good point as to why he's not doing them.
Why?
Let me see if I can find the screenshot.
Because I'm genuinely interested why he won't do the A3s. I'm genuinely interested why he won't do the rest of the members, and two, the sort of the other variations of the A3s.
It's a matter of just all of the shit that the A3s had, i.e. the left and right hand drive, the different like style, the different boiler types, smoke boxes, the three different tenders, plus Scotsman's preserved examples. It would take up a lot of room as a pack whole, and just
Why doesn't he do the same approach that Just Trains did? Just split it over several packs.
Here's the thing.
Split it over several packs. Exactly the same what Victory Works did with the heavy Western tank engines. You know, the 4200s, the 5205s, and then the 7200s. Split it over several packs so that when you get into the sort of like the asset scenario maker and you actually see the box, they're not listed as like pack 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. They're all listed as one pack, but you have to buy them in sections. Like you need sort of like the base one, which is going to be like sort of the Great Northern Railway A1 sort of style, i.e. what Scotsman and Great Northern were like as they were built originally, brand spanking new. But then over the course, you can then buy additional add-on packs where they have like sort of like right-hand drive variants or left-hand drive variants or short travel valve, long travel valve, and all the different variations, etc. But they will all be available in separate packs, which when bought will then be collaborated and put into one major pack.
Yeah.
That's just me anyway. That's how I would work it, because to me, that's pretty much a solid idea. That's pretty much a sort of solid way to do it. Rather than sort of like making a pack that could be like 10, 15, 20 gigabytes as a pack and it'll be absolutely bloody enormous, just split it up over several. Like, have the main base pack as sort of like, what's his normal price? Like, £14, for example. Then over time, sort of like, add in a couple of other ones, i.e. sort of like little marketplace ones, and have them sort of like, maybe like £5 or something like that as you go along.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's not down to me. I'm not a mod maker or anything like that. I'm just a, you know, what some people say, a veteran Railworks user, because I've been playing this game for since it very began in Rail Simulator days of 2008, so pretty much when Tornado was built and actually running. That's how long I've been playing this game, and you know what I say means absolutely fuck all, that's just my thoughts. To me, that's how I personally work it, because I don't think people would have a problem with that, but again, that's just my opinion, and you know, to one person in particular, I'm to keep my stupid opinions to myself, but there you go.
I'm inclined to agree with you, but here's Stephen, but I will also say that Chris does make a valid point. But again, it is also his decision, and
Ben, could you put that in developer's log? Because in the read me first, that's where I said that stuff that is to be put.
Oh, that I didn't even notice that, sorry.
Nah, prime example. You didn't read. You didn't read. See, there you go. You should always read.
But again, I'm also not that torn at the fact that we're just getting the Great Northern and LNERA ones.
Yeah.
Again,
it's a nice thing to sort of like see, and I'm welcoming. But I'm also disheartened at the fact we're not going to see the rest of the A1/A3 members, nor are we going to actually get a proper version of the A3s. They're just going to be left dead in the water, and we'll just have an underscaled and absolutely diabolically shit RSC thing to cope with. Unless people sort of like put in sort of like a money pot donation or something, or have, show enough backing and show enough support to basically say, Chris, look, well, we know it's sort of like not pre-grouping, it's sort of like post-grouping, etc. We know it's that sort of thing, and you don't like doing it, but please, for the love of God, please give us this. Otherwise, we're going to have to wait, if they're ever going to even do it, wait for someone like, you know, Victory Works to do it, whether we can sort of like customise having single chimney, double chimney, round top dome, banjo dome, left hand drive, right hand drive, short travel valves, long travel valves, different to all the different types of smoke deflectors and trials, especially the ones that Humorist had, all the different liveries, etc., the different types of tenders, the Great Northern Railway Coal Rail, non-streamlined non-corridor, non-streamlined corridor, the original style that Scotsman had, if you pay close attention when she had first had her two tenders, the streamlined non-corridor, the streamlined corridor tender, the type that she's now got, the type that she has got now, which shares the same as the A4s, is... Yeah. There is so much that the Gresley A1s, Great Northern Railway /NNR A1/A3s have basically done and had as modifications. I understand that, but it is such a bloody pity that we're only just going to get, in effect, the prototype, or as some people may consider it, and I even hate even saying this, we're only going to get the Gordon version. I understand where Chris is from, but considering the fact that pretty much the base plate for the rest of the members and the A3 variants is pretty much down, it's, you know, yes, it, obviously there's more scripting and rest of it involved, i.e. the boiler is different to that of the A1s and everything else. I understand all that, but it's considering the fact there was no sort of like real mechanical difference, i.e. the driving wheels weren't different, the rods weren't different, etc. Everything was basically there, the base plate, i.e. from the rolling ball down, was exactly the same. Even the cab was basically the bloody same. But in terms of like the controls, whether it was right hand drive to left hand drive, the A1 boiler to the A3 boiler, the round top dome to the banjo dome, the single chimney, double chimney, etc. It's just the fact that all those, again, I just feel like I'm not wasting my breath per se, but it feels like I'm dragging on about something that I have a feeling I know is never going to happen, or we're never going to see. Just because, and I mean no offence by this, just because someone said it's too much work.
Considering the amount of work he already has with all of the projects, the engines that he wants to get out.
It's like, I don't even know whether it's still kicking about. I still remember, sort of like, I think he just did the front end of it. I still remember the rendered front end he did. Similar to that, what he did to the Great Northern Railway A1. I still remember the render he did of the front end of an A4, and we all lost our shit because we wanted it so bad.
He got it into game, into the silver street configuration. But then his computer took a dump on itself.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember that.
But no, that was the full, it was a full LNERA A4, or tender and all.
Yeah.
Pretty sure what would have been 2509.
Yeah, and what people, I'm not sure, I'm quite sure if people realise this, but there was actual very significant cosmetic. There was actually very significant cosmetic changes between the silver streaks and the streaks that we know now. Like the buffers were sunk in more to the bodywork. The coupling hook was definitely sunk in. The handrails along the side was different. I think the valances were slightly different as well. There were small little details between the original silver streaks and they were compared to the rest of the sort of like the mass batch, as it were, sort of like the rest of the A4s. There were actually quite a lot of differences.
Yeah, there were a fair amount between the silver streaks and the batch that followed.
Now, one thing I will say, just to protect my own arse, because I know that someone's going to bloody grass up on me and trying to give my name a sort of like a nasty, sort of like violent, sort of like cancerous name within the community, more so than what people are trying to want me to make it. But in regards to what Mike Hannibal said, I don't want to sound like I'm on the sort of like the bandwagon bus or sort of like hating on Chris. I'm not going to say that whatsoever. Just to protect my honest, I don't hate sort of like hate on Chris for this whatsoever. Obviously, there are sort of like reasons and explanations for this, and I can quite readily understand that. But what, because in regards to what Mike Hannibal said, he basically went, quote, it's too much work. He went, yet the same person managed to do the Great Western 3000s with the ROD pack, i.e. the Great Western sort of like RODs.
Yeah. Actually, Steve, I'm going to post this in real life railways of silver wing. Note the placement of the coupling hook. It's in the front end a lot more.
Yeah, that's what I said. The actual coupling hook itself is sunk into the front end of the locomotive a lot more. And as I said, there were a lot of cosmetic changes between the a brand new original streaks and compared to the others. I mean, again, look at the handrails. Rather than it sort of like sloping down where the firebox is, look, it goes straight along. It's perfectly horizontal all the way along.
As soon as slow mode finishes, there we go. There's a one of the waiters. Just as kind of comparison from like almost the same angle.
Mm.
The only shame is the fucking image is so small.
Mm.
But yeah, there are distinct differences as to what the main batch, what the second batch had and what the first four had.
Yeah, I think my sound card's packing up.
Is the sound glitch still there?
The glitch is still there. I can still hear it. You can just hear it going, if you're looking very carefully, you can still hear it. So my sound card's on the way out, which proves my PC is actually, right now, my PC is actually physically dying. I don't know what I can do to sort of like help the sound card, because you know I don't think there's any, you know, I can, unlike the sort of like the graphics card, where like I can with the sort of like GeForce Experience, where I can with sort of like my graphics drivers, I don't think I can check it in the same way with the sort of like the sound card. It's pretty much install it and just leave it. I don't think there is any way to check if it needs any updates.
Listening to the stream, I can kind of hear like a whirring sound. Is that the sound you're referring to, Stephen?
No, you can. No, it's kind of like you know when you put the sort of the plug in, you know, the sort of the audible jack point, the sort of like the male end on the headphones. You know when you sort of like plug that into the port, and sometimes you sort of like get that distorted sort of like audio pixel, sort of like almost like an audio sort of like popping.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about, Steve.
Like the analog sort of like. Sort of noise. I'm not quite sure how to sort of describe it, but that's the sort of noise I'm hearing every now and then, along with the sort of like the odd little like that, the sort of like the odd little sort of like jerk and seizure. That's what I'm hearing, and that to me sounds like the sound card packing up.
I don't think it's a sound card because I can't hear it on the stream. I don't hear that sound you're hearing on your stream, Stephen.
If it's not my sound card, what the hell could it be?
Check the connection. Check the headphones. It might be them. Because I actually cannot hear the sound you're on about on stream, Stephen. Yeah, Charlie's agreeing with me. He says your headphones might be packing up.
But they're 2 months old. These headphones I got are 2 fucking months old.
Right, I heard it a hell of a lot when I was in the map just now.
But, yeah, generally, I can't hear it on stream. Like, it's actually not picking up on stream, Steven.
Right, hold on then. Pause break, because on my end, when I just did the pause break, I heard it go. I just heard it do that.
Charlie, it could be the input port on your PC itself.
Oh, hold on, I need to have a look at what's going on in the server thing, because people are asking for approvals.
Yeah.
So Jaden, you've done it. Daniel's done it. Ethan W's done it. Now, Oliver, on the other hand, you've used the wrong kind of brackets. But I can modify that for you. It's the square ones, not the round ones. The ones that are just after the letter P on the keyboard. They're the ones that you use. So that's them. And I'm just waiting for this Stefan B to basically do the same.
Hannibal says he can hear something whirring. I heard that too, Michael. But it didn't sound like what Steven was describing.
I can hear something whirring, yeah. Maybe a motherboard audio connector. Oh god, that's the last thing I need if the motherboard is actually on its fucking way up. That's the last thing I need. The actual heart and brains of the whole fucking thing. That's the very last thing I need. I mean, I know my PC is old and gone to fucking high hell. Let's have a look, see.
Yeah, on the stream I can kind of hear like a whirring sound, like almost like a fan or something. But I don't know if that's just your PC's fan, Steve.
anything. Change it again. Video and voice. Default. Volume. Hello.
There you are.
Right, okay. I apologise to anyone in the stream, but I'm doing as a test. I'm running this. I'm going to be running this without my headphones in, because I want to see if it may be the jack port in the actual tower itself that's given me this issue. Because if I can still hear it through the monitor, then it's definitely something to do with the PC. Golden Heart. Oh, we just heard some pops. See, that could be me trying to sort of like plug in the port in different ways. Right, so let's have a listen. Oh, great. Now I can't hear the game. Right, okay then. If it's going to act like that, then I wonder. Does this one have? Oh, it does. The monitor actually has a headphone port. Right, say something, Ben. Right, okay, right. I've plugged my headphones into the back of the monitor itself. And I'm hoping I'll be able to hear the game from them as well. No, I can't. Right, so I've lost. Fucking marvellous. Right, okay, I have lost complete and utter audio from the game because it doesn't like it when you change different sound settings. Fucking marvellous. Yes, it's such an outdated piece of crap, it really is. Trainmaster, have you tried asking your PC nicely to work? It's never worked properly since I bought the fucking thing in 2014. I'm gonna hit it with a fucking Bible in a minute. I mean, I don't have one in the house, but I'll fucking hit it with one. That is a point. I mean, again, I don't wish to sort of like be a hater as such, but that is one thing I kind of wish Chris didn't actually do in every fucking locomotive he ever makes. A Bible in the cab, because I'm pretty sure the locomotive crews were not as religious as fuck. I'm pretty bloody sure they weren't, especially on the NNER. Because I don't mind seeing like the old smoking pup, etc. I don't mind seeing that in the cab. But a fucking Bible is clear as hell. That's pretty much as the biggest thing I've ever seen in the cab. It's probably the biggest thing in the cab entirely. It looks like it's even bigger than the bloody spade on the shovel. I mean, it's not every single locomotive carried a locomotive crew had a Bible with them at all bloody times. I'm pretty bloody sure they never did. I don't even think locomotive crews were, in England were even that bloody religious. That's kind of one thing I wish he sort of like, not completely stopped, but sort of like didn't do as much of, or at least made a sort of like a small little, I don't know, little handheld thing somewhere resting on the sort of like the back of the sort of like the cab, the back of the actual tender or bunker or something like that, rather than being in plain sight as big as you can fucking imagine in the cab somewhere. I mean, yeah, I understand that he's a full on blown Christian, as you can tell in the sort of like the manuals and that, but I would just, he's, ugh. Again, I just feel like it's
It does. It's. I mean, again, at the end of the day, he's a developer. He can do whatever the fuck he wants. I can understand that, but it's starting to get to the point for me personally. It's just kind of taking the piss now. Golden Heart. No, Stephen. It's the Bible for the Bible. The paper is used for the. The pages of the Bible are used for the fucking fire. Trainmaster, it's better than having a 1-to-1 scale portrait of Jesus. Oh, that can fuck right off. I'm sorry, but I believe in science and in evolution, not somebody white cloak wearing hobo that goes, I create man. Now I create woman. I don't believe that bollocks. Yeah, what white cloaked hobo? Yeah, one wearing sandals as well. Have you not heard of socks? Again, I mean no offense, but it's just fucking dumb. Oh God, look what Stefan the Victorian rail guns were just said. Not as bad as a cross as the lamp iron. But Tiana said I've somehow never noticed. Noticed it when I've been playing, though. That is true. To be fair, you don't sort of like really notice it, but when you're sort of like moving at different camera views and looking around and you spot it, it's kind of not impossible to notice it. You might want to close and come back in. It might have performed a derp. Hello. Dinner for Hall. Watch it. Just having a look at the images that Oliver's just put in. My cannibal. To be fair, you wouldn't see bus drivers carrying Bibles, etc. Well, no, they wouldn't. You wouldn't see bus drivers carrying Bibles. Not physically on them, anyway. They'd just be tucked away in sort of like a leather, like a rucksack or something like that. Oh, Ben's gone. What's happened to him? Not unless he's completely rebooting Discord. Yeah, I think he's completely rebooted Discord. Hello, Moto? Hold on, let me reboot my Discord because it could be mine messing up as well. Oh, this is all going so swimmingly. Not. Computer. Desktop. Down, where is it? There we are, Norham Valley. Edit. Ben? There you are. Yeah, I decided to reboot. I decided to reboot my Discord as well. And I'm Goldenart, and I am back. What's happening? Bullshit has occurred. My PC seems to be developing a glitch. Went off on a rant about a Bible. Oh. You can't, hold on, you can't hear your response. What? Right, say something now, Ben.
Your mum.
And again?
Memes.
Right, when you was talking, the OBS Discord, well, so the OBS sort of like desktop audio wasn't moving, but now it's moving.
Hmm. That's weird.
Hey, Train Master, we can't hear the other guy. I forgot his name. And all of a sudden, almost at the same time, yay!
What's this called now? Hey, Stephen, what do you think about Gmod train build? Well, there's quite a fan base behind it, and I commend them for it.
Yeah.
Who's this? Oh, this looks like a new one as well. Elliot Baker Skellhorn. That's a fucking surname and an R. It's a double barrel one as well, because of the dash. It's a double-barreled surname. Bloody hell. Midland Compound. Oh, my God. Midland Compound 1000. What the hell? Where the hell have you been? God. I remember you having the actual avatar picture of the... literally a head-on shot of Midland Compound 1000. God, where the hell have you been? Sorry, being dead. If you've been dead, who the fuck am I talking to then? A hologram? Right, after nearly an hour and 40 minutes, could I actually do a run with this logo? Found the Discord desktop audio down by nearly just shy of 24 decibels. Is that any better for anyone? Have you got a SnowRunner, Ben?
No, I don't.
Oh, you need to get it. It's so bloody fun. Is it because SnowRunner is basically the third generation of spin tires?
I never played spin tires either.
Oh my god, right, you definitely need to get it now. Just how Dane forced me to get Derail Valley, you must buy. Buy. Yeah, as much as I like American Railroad Summit, Summit River to Pine Valley, as much as we can't hear Ben. Oh, great! So it's a clash between the two. So it's either hear the game and hear Ben. Try and speak, mate. Can anybody hear you now? Over the edge.
The banana!
Banana!
Game audio got a lot louder, and so did, I'm pretty sure so did mine.
Oh my god, that's why. Right. How is it for people now?
I can. Game audio got a lot quieter, but I don't know about my audio on stream. Okay, yeah, mine's fine.
Okay, because I had to look at the open volume mixer, and I noticed that when I switched over from the audio settings I had it before to what it is now, it basically reset the levels, and I originally had TS at 25% and everything else left at 4. When I switched it over, it reset it, so it shoved TS back on full volume. Yeah, it must be. What did I say? You're about 8 hours behind.
It's 3:46 for me.
Yeah. It's coming up to, well, it's practically quarter to 12 here, so it's coming up to noon.
Yep.
Number or something. I can see all the buffer beam on the back of this thing. Look at this.
Oh yeah, I can see that.
I wonder what that is. There must be some sort of like carriage identification number for the chassis, isn't it? Something like that.
Either that or it's something similar to what the Southern did with their carriages.
What, sort of like a coach set number?
Yeah.
a bloody big greenhouse in it. That's, I suppose that might represent some sort of like shopping, like a garden centre or something. I can't tell if the track has duplicated itself here. Yeah, it has, because the frog here's lapping over, so the points are sort of like overlapping. That's odd. It's fine on that end, but it's not on that end. So that point's glitching out.
TS route building in a nutshell.
Yeah, pretty much. Well, TS was out of date when it was still being bloody made. So we are at, where are we at? This is
you back? Yeah, you're back at the junction.
Yeah, this is Wessenden.
Weasel Town.
Oh, I like the little sheds here. I like how they sort of like interpreted that. That's quite nice. That's quite homely.
Yes.
Very nice. I might actually use one of those sort of sheds in my Bradnob and Kingston route I'm trying to make.
Yeah.
The word being trying. All the points are set. What's the... Oh, what do I see over there?
Have you spotted something, Stephen?
Yeah.
What English, please? What have you spotted?
Up, down, go hot dog, bottom of my undershirt, blah, blah, blah. Oh, clever. I've seen what they've done. They've used, the person's used bridge assets and pipeline, which I'm assuming, for what they were trying to do, to represent like a water treatment facility, like some sort of like a water pump or something like that. Because in fact, there were pumps coming out of a building and going into like sort of like the lake. Well, is it a lake? Yeah, some sort of like lake. It could be a reservoir, couldn't it?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
But clever use of the assets. Where'd my train go? Oh, there it is. There's my little J21.
Yeah, there's Arlesborough. I'm going to take a look at the area around it. I've just downloaded the route, Stephen. And I might try a loaded run up the grade, just for the hell of it.
I love this little J21, I really do.
And in the words of you, rods.
I tell you what, if I was to ever make merchandise, like anyone would even buy them anyway, one of the captions probably on sort of like on my mugs and t-shirts and that, I guarantee you, would be red rods. Guarantee that would be the first thing demanded on the merch, is red rods.
Steve, when you get down to Arlesborough, there is kind of like a banker station here, a banker's section here. For the grade.
Oh, going through a little halt. What's this? That's... Oh, I was sort of right. Wessenden Power Dam.
Oh, that's what it is.
Wait, a dam? Oh, bloody hell. So it is. Look at this.
Just waiting for the stream to catch up.
Oh, bugger me. It's a bloody dam. Clever, bloody clever. And holy hell.
That's nice.
This must be some sort of like solid assets or something, because if this person has painstakingly made individual assets look like this, holy bloody hell, this must actually be some sort of like damn asset block. I've never seen anything like this. Actually, it might have come from the sort of like a canal pack or something like that.
Considering this route's been in development for about three years. The person who made this has had a lot of time to experiment with stuff.
By the looks of things, if I go into here like this, that looks like a separate asset. So that looks like stairs. They've enlarged a bunch of stairs.
Yeah.
But that's bloody clever. That is bloody clever. It's got like a damn door there. That is bloody clever how they've used that.
That is really cool.
Oh! I think we've missed a bunch of stuff. Oh god.
Have you?
I've set myself into the bloody goods loop.
Oh no.
It's alright, no dead end. But switch those points there. And then switch the points back there. Oh wait a minute, I think I should switch the same set of points by accident. Right, so if I bung that there, wind the reverser down a bit, and then just have that throttle cracked open. I'm not really too sure about the signal box being on this side of the fencing, considering the fact that any Joe Blogson could just come along the road and just do shit to the signal box. So whether the fence needs to sort of like be built around the signal box instead, because really it's got primary access to here, just in case the signalman needs to get to the train to basically attempt to like flag them down or talk to the crew, etc. like that, because it'll be a bit difficult for the signalman to try and talk to them on the other side of the fence.
Well, then he could also just shout from the box.
So, oh, yeah, dying bar. Oh, just got past something. I'm missing so many assets. Well, not missing so many assets, but I'm sort of like missing the entire point of looking around the route. As people have been saying, you need red rods. Apparently, according to Midland Compound, I need a Red Rods theme song. What do you expect me to do? Do a spin-off Cars Mater song where it goes, Dagum, Dagum, but it goes, Red Rods, Red Rods.
Hey, Dane.
Oh, Dane. Ah, it's a TPO apparatus.
Yeah, there's a couple of them around the route.
Oh, this is another new one I've seen. The blue parallel. Oh, the blue parallelogram. Tiana, Red Rod's the musical.
Red Rod's the musical. It's like, who said it? Who said this like a while? Hey, we'll go GWR 6029 the musical. I'm pretty sure that was Shiloh that said that.
Well, I'm going to stop here. If I can even stop in time. If there was a Red Rod song, it'll be into the start of Bad Boys. Red Rods, Red Rods, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they spin for you?
That is great.
Oh god, now there's just a bloody armada of people just going Red Rods the movie, Red Rods Dem Bones and all the rest of it. Oh wait a minute, Red Rods the tune of Dem Bones. Hold on, Dem Bones. So you basically want you expect the Red Rod song to go? How did it used to go? The Red Rods are connected to the driving wheels. The driving wheels are connected to the axles. Not quite sure about what they mean by that. Red Rods to the tune of Beyblade theme.
Oh, I know what they're f***ing on about. I'll send you the theme in PMC. So basically it's gonna be like Red Rods, Red Rods, let them spin. if it's either that or the old
Red
theme
Rod,
tune.
Red Rod engine gathering. What? Oh, I think you mean gathering. Red Rods to flag. Oh my god, everyone's just going off about Red Rods now.
I don't know which Beyblade theme they mean. I'm just going to assume it's
so
this
one. So what
one
was we at? We just left Lin 4.
I think you're at the top of the hill, Steven. I'm at Arlesborough climbing with a Robinson 04 on a coal train.
Oh yeah, because there's because right down at the very other end, it looks like I just saw Crescent Colliery.
And starting off from Arlesborough, at least where I started, next to the banker siding, it's 1 in 150.
Oh God, Red Rod's the cereal.
Red Rod's the cereal. Actually, I'm gonna PM Golden on Discord, see which Beyblade series you mean.
They're spinning right round, baby, right round. That's what Red Rod should be doing, right round, round, round. Red Rod's engines versus Silver Rod's engines.
that could be what? A race or something.
What the kick? Hold on, the Kit Kat biscuit. Sun Supreme never made austerities.
No.
Not unless he's thinking about that.
Unless he's on about the dub D's then.
No, I think I know what he's on about. If he's saying Steam Sun Supreme's austerity, I bet he means that the one that Horrocks made. That saddle tank. You know, like Rip Raw.
Yeah.
I bet that's what he's on about.
I think that might have one with them.
Oh my god. You've committed treason, but somehow I want to see it. Well, GWR5320 just put 488 with red rods. WD has blue rods. Yeah, well, that's what the Long War Military Railway had. Some engines had blue, some of them left them plain, and in terms of Gordon's case, the 210O, it had red rods. Some austerities had it as well.
Okay, see, I found the 1 in 50 you were talking about earlier.
Yep.
I've got 22 16 tonners from the Return to Marty pack, and the Robinson is slowly climbing at 17 and a half.
The middle combat 1000. I started it, so I'll stop it. Red rods. Actually, oh god, it's noon. I need to do something for anyone. Where is it? Oh god, don't minimize bloody Discord, you belling. Where is
Dine
it? I need to. Select 1 hour maximum users. No, generate that. Copy. Right, going. Where is it? Going into the chat now. If anybody hasn't joined yet, going into the chat now is a 1 hour Discord link to the server. That is a 1 hour link. There's no like X amount of users expiry. It's there for 1 hour, so that will that will close at 1 p.m. Depending if I'm even still going for that long.
Most likely you will, because it's really...
Why is my J21 slowing down? Oh my god, I'm on the 1 in 100.
Oh yeah, you're on the 1 in 100 until, like, what, the colliery?
I don't know, but I need to open her up again. And we're slowing, this ain't good.
Yeah, I think this section of line you're on, Stephen, is about for 2 miles to the colliery. And the section that I'm on is about for, 6 miles of 1 in 50?
Well, I'll tell you what, I need to put some...
I need to put some
I think the tunnels that the dev used for this route are from the settle to Carlisle, because I forgot I was shoveling when I entered the tunnel and I didn't get fatal blow jobs. Now this would be a good route for the RP.
Yeah. Oh right, okay, so hold on. There's this mic 61163 needs to comply with the rules, this Nico needs to do the same, and the Kentish man also needs to do the same.
Hold on, what is
the Kentish man's got the picture words. Is it right? That's cool. But yeah, you guys, Mike 61163, Nicolaj, if I pronounce it correctly, and the Kentish man, you need to comply with the rules as I've stated, just like what everybody else has done, to make sure they be approved. Go on, little Chain 21, you little beauty. But honestly, this engine, out of all the locomotives and DLCs I've ever driven, this J21 has got the most beautiful and harmonious beat at 25 miles an hour. It's so bloody beautiful. I could listen to this engine at 25 miles an hour all day, every day. It's got such a beautiful little rhythm. It really bloody has. I know there's apparently Minecraft train communities and the rest of it in there. I know that is a thing, but I've personally never got around to Minecraft, because if I'm purely honest, it's something that doesn't really take my fancy. It's something that, you know, I haven't been convinced enough of that it's actually, you know, worth getting, etc. I haven't been persuaded enough. It hasn't tickled my fancy. I got Wreckfest though, which is what did it used to be called? It used to be called Next Target. Got that.
It was Next Target, yeah.
And I've also got Planetary Annihilation, which they very rebranded themselves as a sort of like the Titans versions now.
Red Rod's the Kit Kat bar.
Yeah, the blue parallelogram has been saying that nearly almost constantly now.
Okay, parallelogram, can you please stop with that?
God, how long does this tunnel go on for? I'm still going up the 1 in 100.
Standard gauge and narrow gauge. You can customize the track so you can have like a miniature gauge railroad as well.
Yeah,
What's the next, what's the nearest thing to you, Steven? Like, the next station?
Nearest one for me, God, there's a hell of a gap until the next station.
Oh, you're almost at a colliery.
Next one will be Aldsborough.
Okay, we're almost gonna meet Stephen because I'm just gone over what's it. Bankton down Main.
Ah, there's a marker here. Norren Valley Summit up Main. And it looks like I'm just about to come out of the tunnel mouth.
Yeah.
There we are, on the level now.
Okay, so yeah, you're at the summit about to go down the 1 in 50. I'm still climbing the 1 in 50.
Oh, that's interesting how the combined semaphore is sunk into the ground like that.
Yeah. So, drive. So when you.
And I forgot you can get a signal box that's that tall.
Yep.
I completely forgot about that.
Bottom of the hill, except I'm gonna have no engine at the front and just bank the train. Actually, no, I'm gonna set it as a dead engine and just bank the train up with an INF. That's not it.
Oh, bloody hell, look at the view!
Yeah, it's stunning.
What the flying fuck is going on outside?
That's your dad.
No, it's a fucking big ass 7.5 ton white van outside, blocking the entire close, and I don't know what the hell it's doing. Oh. It looks like in the distance on my end, I can see a building, so it looks like the colliery down below. Crescent up. Yeah, I must be near the colliery.
Yeah, you're near the colliery. I've restarted at the bottom of the hill on the 1 in 150 in Aylesborough. Because my O4 was not having it. I've basically set it as a dead engine and I'm going to bank it up with an INF. I will say banking in this game is kind of broken, but at the same time it also works slightly.
Oh, I hold the phone.
Hmm.
This set point works a bit broken.
Where?
Once you see it on my stream.
Oh yeah, I see it.
That's done a bit of a glitchy boo-boo. Yeah, so there's a colliery down below.
I'm gonna post a couple of pictures in railwork stuff, Steve.
Mm-hmm.
Where are they?
Humble little abandoned little mine down there. That's clever. Is that actually several different buildings put together, or is it actually one solid object?
I think, yeah, that's different buildings.
It's a bunch of different buildings.
Thank you.
I've just noticed here, there's a small little cottage set here, and there's a small little stream run to the back of it. I mean, yeah, it's the same level as the building, so, you know, if it overflows even slightly, it's going to go into their back door and destroy the kitchen. Then they'll have to go to bloody IKEA to rent one, considering the fact, I still can't believe this, that there was a thing I read a while ago about how IKEA were going to stop making like stuff that you can build, and then instead they were going to make stuff for you to rent. It's like, why would you rent a, like, a kitchen worktop or something like that? How dumb can you be?
Yeah. Oh, Stephen.
Here we go. What's this one? This is Creston Vale Hall. Oh, I like this. Sort of like the Gerd of Viaduct Bridge afterwards. I do like that a lot.
That's nice.
And especially with it going right over these pine trees as well. These tall... No, they're not pine trees, are they? They're like fir trees.
Yeah.
I do like that a hell of a lot.
Yeah, Steve, if you look in railroad pics just for like a second.
Hold on, need to stop injecting water now. Right, let's have a look. Oh, hold on a second. So that's... Hey, what? I swear I just saw someone in here and they just buggered off. Oh no, they literally just went offline. So, Joshua, that's that now. What else have we got? We got George S. That needs to be modified slightly. There we are. And now it just leaves a James 7298, a Mike 60163 still, that Nicolaj, if I'm pronouncing it correctly, and Train Master 15 has just come in. I'm going down to one in 90.
Yeah, Steve, the screenshots I just shared in Railwork stuff are from the route Calvin made. That's basically has some aspects of Sodor on it, but not a whole lot. It's more just fictional than anything.
Oh, okay.
And it does actually have the correct grade for Golden Sickle, and surprisingly a Jinxie can bank a Black 5 up the hill, no problem.
Hmm. Oh! I spot another bridge-like viaduct. Ooh. A brick one right through the heart of a forest. Holy hell.
Oh, I know that route. It's on UKTS. It actually has the wiki on it.
No, then I've not played it then. PBR Red, so that's Ethan. Morning. Ethan, what do you think of 2 foot, 15 inch, 7.25 inch gauge? 7.25 inch gauge is lovely. 2 foot's nice. But I'm in love with the 15 inch gauge purely because of Romney Heidenmann's chest. Because RHMD are for the fucking win, really. Oh god!
Yeah, you're going.
Didn't pay attention, I was doing a 64 down to 50.
I think you've no, you've not passed me yet, because I'm just still getting out the first tunnel out of Arlesbrook.
Well, I'm about to go past Bankton Up.
That's the next stop for me, Stephen.
Well, Bankton Up Main, anyway.
Yeah.
But seriously, I adore 15-inch gauge, because they've gone behind the Denny Church. I adore that line to high hell. Someone did actually say about the Romney. Someone that did actually try and make a sort of like a standard gauge interpretation of the Romney Harding Dimension from the workshop, and I did actually have a little play with it, but it does require a fair bit of work. I mean, it's a good attempt nonetheless. I commend him from actually having a go, but it does need a little bit of seeing to. Second time on my end. This is the one in 50. Good God.
Okay, yeah, you're actually about to pass me.
Oh, coming out of the second tunnel.
Tell me when you're passing the signal box.
I'm about to pass it now, because it's right next to the viaduct.
Right, tell me if you see a 04 being banked by a 9F.
It's single player, mate. We all know that this isn't multiplayer.
I know. I'm just joking.
Oh, this has a curve on it. Ooh. Right, I've left that viaduct. Still going down the 1 in 50.
You'll know when you're off the 1 in 50 when you get to
going through
Be careful, Steve. Check the points down towards Arlesbrook around the banker side, because it will try to switch you onto the down line.
I've just seen it on the HUD. Yeah, it is. Let's switch that over. This even got a bloody turntable here.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just put pigeon, sir. There's a pigeon in our trench. There was a route that added working 15-inch gauge and 7.25-inch gauge, but you can't get it anymore. I tell you one thing I would absolutely love to do, considering the fact apparently it can be done, but apparently there's a sort of like a multiplayer mod the community or someone has made for Microsoft Train Simulator. I'm not quite sure what it's actually called, but it's not called like Microsoft Train Simulator sort of multiplayer mode. I think it's something like OpenTDD or something like that, where apparently you can basically take Microsoft Train Simulator sort of like locos and assets and routes and the rest of it, and basically go multiplayer with it. And one of the things I would absolutely, yeah, and the one thing I would absolutely love to do, considering the fact I think you can still get a hold of it, is, and I will generally reinstall Microsoft Train Simulator for this, is you can actually get the Romney Hyde and Dimchurch for sort of like for MSTS, and I will hand on heart reinstall Microsoft Train Simulator, go out and buy, if it is still available, the Romney Hyde and Dimchurch sort of like add-on packs and locos, etc., and I mean every fucking thing for it, for MSTS, and we'll happily do like that. What was it? What Stuart's putting? Open Rails. I'll happily do a multiplayer Open Rails thing on the Romney if it can be done. If it can really can be done with the Romney Hyde and Dimchurch pack and DLC in that, I will fucking leap to it. So far, I'm genuinely liking this route, and bear in mind that it's just over 30 miles in length as well.
Yeah.
Oh, I like these sheds here.
Yeah.
a second. Wow, did RSC really be bloody lazy? This is the old wooden shed, the single, the sort of like the twin slash single road wooden shed that they have literally painted the bottom half of it in brick.
Yeah, I was gonna say from those sheds, Steve, and I'm getting vibes from your 2000 sub special with 1422.
Yeah, little Tivy.
Yeah.
I feel so sorry for that little 1400 and the fact that she's stuck and shut up inside a converted goods shed. I feel so sorry for that little engine. I feel so sorry for little Tivy.
It's not even that far away from Tiverton Parkway as well.
That's why she was preserved, because she used to be based there.
Yeah.
Oh my god, Cam just fucking quoted Father Ted. I love my brick!
God damn it, Cam.
Oh, those sheds came with Port Road. Oh, if they came with Port Road, did that mean, oh, DTG might not have done it. Well, I say DTG, RSC might not have done it then, unless they put in a couple of things in with it. Because who made it? It was Keith M. Ross, wasn't it, that made Port Road?
Yeah, it was Keith M. Ross.
Yeah.
Because I remember he released it originally in sections on UKTS, and then it came out as a full group with RSC.
Well, this is interesting. The station's right at that. Another how many tunnels does this route have?
Many, right. It's Wales. It's kind of Wales.
Right, so the start of it is literally just here where the tunnel mouth is, where the station is. Oh, it doesn't look like it. Doesn't look like it's that long. But this is what I find interesting. Is that you see on the map here on my end, you can see the basically the entrance to the tunnel section here, like the sort of the icon for it here. And considering the fact that the entrance to the tunnel mouth, as you probably saw it just a moment ago on the screen, is literally at the sort of like the edge of the platforms, it's not showing.
Yeah, it's a little weird.
Oh god, someone just emerged from the brickwork. Well, the brickwork, the cliff face, rather. Oh my god, Mr. Dark just fucking did the same. You creepy bastard.
Like, I have come... Allow me to introduce myself.
They're appearing like the bloody... goat, one of the... They're appearing like the ghost from Doctor Who that actually turned out to be fucking Cybermen.
Come to inspect the J21 for you to be able to see.
These bastards are ignoring the J21. This one's literally looking back at the cliff face, and this one's literally looking at very oddly shaded cliff faces. You ignorant bastards! You absolute ignorant bastards! How dare you turn your head away from a J21?
I fart in your genital direction.
That was my very weak impression of doing a raspberry against my hand. Oh, I say.
Hello, Estima.
They've turned away because it's not J36.
Oh my god, I'm speaking to a bloody McDonald's representative. Yeah, I'll have two number nines.
No. You're talking to the Domino's representative.
Domino's representative.
Because I've got pizza right here.
When do you not have pizza?
When I've got macaroni cheese.
Or cereal.
Or cereal, yeah. I had some earlier. And I've got a bar of Dairy Milk in front of me as well. But that's for my cup of tea later. Speaking of which, I need Iron Brew.
To which I still have 6 litres left in the porch.
I've been working on James's route for the past few days.
That was 1442 at Tiverton. Not 1422, yeah. I'm a dumbass.
Cam just put boo, J36, boo, give me J70 instead.
Ethan, I want that A2.
Hey, what's going on?
In railwork
stuff. I want that A2.
Ethan, you bugger, you beat me. Ethan, you bugger, you beat me to it. You actually put the Bossman Games A2 in blue. Gib.
I want it. Peppercorn will be going in blue. And it will be going in blue for Wibblefest.
Oh, I like K Valley Junction. If I actually manage to fucking stop in time.
Stuart, if for Wibblefest, you're more than welcome to put the my standard 2 in green. Just for the lols.
You're welcome to borrow my bug in the my bug in fictitious NMS Crimson. Not bug, Gronk.
I was going to say, since when did we have Drummond's speed demon? Now for another slice of pizza.
Another? What, is one never good enough?
No, because I finished the first one.
But yeah, I do like...
Oh,
I do like
K-Valley.
It's 2 for
Tuesday today.
Ethan, that Grezzly reskin is looking nice.
Yeah, let's have a look. Oh my fucking god. Sir Nigel Grezzly in Garter Blue with transitional BR on it with... Oh my god.
And Stephen has to replace his trousers.
What trousers?
What trousers?
That is nice. That really is bloody nice.
Screw the purists, because it's got something it never wore during that condition.
Yeah, that A2 though in blue. Such a pity that there's no single chimney peppercorn A2s, because they did exist. And the single chimney peppercorn A2s weren't converted later to double chimney. They kept the single chimneys. They kept them.
Some kept them, some didn't.
I didn't know they had single chimneys.
Each peppercorn has one.
James S. Hold on, before I approve. There, can't fucking speak.
Let me have a look
James
at my.
James S. Oh, you've got the. Oh, well, I'm not surprised. You've got the. What is it? The. Caledonian Railway, what is it? 36, that mogul in the bloody James reskin.
24.
Oh, 24 in the James reskin. Well, I'm not surprised. So, that's you approved. Now I'm just literally waiting on Mike 6163, that Nicola. That Nico and Trainmaster 15 to acquire and buy to the username rules, which literally just involves sort of like changing the nickname. Oh, talk of the devil, Mike 2968 has just done it, so
Thompson, Peppercorn.
Just waiting for the others.
Yeah, some of the single chimney ones did receive it later. Blue Peter was one of those examples.
Speaking of chimneys, here's an interesting fun fact, because me and Cam actually came across this the last week or the week before when we was watching the documentary, what about him? But you know David Shepherd's 9F Black Prince?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
She's even more special than what we all thought.
She got a double chimney.
She was the very first 9F in the range to actually receive the double chimney. She was the very first engine in the later batch to start having a double chimney. She was the first double chimney 9F to be built.
Okay. So she was built with a...
double chimney as standard.
Okay.
She was the first range of 9Fs to receive a double chimney, to which the rest followed, and then the others... then some of the ones that had a single chimney sometimes later on received it, and then some didn't, obviously. But Black Prince was the very first 9F to be built as standard with a double chimney. She was the first in the batch to receive it.
Mine didn't. Mine was a single chimney.
Speaking of which, SSS.
More like Victory Works.
I'd say someone go and make us a new 9F that isn't a certain person with the initials JH.
Yeah, so we're looking at Victory Works or Bossman Games. In fact, speaking of DLCs, if I was to place money or convince any, or basically ask like hell of a developer to make a particular engine, or I want only this developer to make this engine in particular, hands down, without any shadow of a doubt, considering the fact he's the only one that's made a working version of it, Bossman Games making the Duke of Gloucester. Considering the fact he's the only one that's made working Caprotti valve gear, all like the motions and the prop rods, etc., all moving. He's the only one that's doing so. So if I was to say anyone, Bossman Games for Duke of Gloucester for 71,000.
I'd put my money on Bossman for making a princess's.
Oh, you know how much I want the Princess Royals. You know how much I want them.
Backing them up, I'm just going to get a drink.
I like this as well.
What route is it?
It's called Norran Valley. It's the link to it is in the description of the stream. It's just over 30 miles, and it actually runs on the old Barlow to Bournemouth line. It uses the old trackbed for it. So technically, although it's a fictitious line with the sort of station names, etc., the trackbed is real.
Sounds like, what'd you call it? Geno SR lines to an extent. Because that roughly follows where the Great North of Scotland ran.
Oh, you like this? It's got water troughs on this route. And TPOs.
I'd rather have the markers for the TPOs for where the TPOs would be placed rather than have them on the route itself. Because I've had problems with my route doing that, doing something with me, where I've had all the TPOs placed and had nothing as for being picked up, and it just crashed whenever I tried to set an AI train.
I can't remember what was the keyboard shortcut for the water troughs for the these type of locos.
Control T.
I want to see if would the J21 have that feature.
Well, look at the tender and you'll find out.
No. Damn it. According to Trainmaster 15, someone is making a crab.
Who's making a crab?
I don't know, but according to Trainmaster 15, someone's making a crab.
If you could tell me who, that would be nice. Might be getting confused with the Stania Mogul.
Yeah, that is true.
Because that's the lobster, not the crab. Fucking typical, I close TS, what happens? Out of memory. You run out of memory closing yourself, you twat. ladders on Instagram. I bet you it'll be BMG.
Another bloody tunnel.
I love these tunnels.
Well, it's what, if that's what the old bar at the what is it, Bournemouth line had.
The Bala Lake to Barmouth.
Yeah.
Look, yeah,
according to Terry, this room is similar to the Settlement Carlisle.
No, Settlement Carlisle doesn't have nearly as many tunnels as this does.
Unless you're going from Carlisle to Applegate.
True.
Some of these tunnels are like ridiculously long.
Would you say about the same or longer than the Ribblehead?
Longer. There's two branch lines, so there's one there. Where's the other branch? Or was that the other, or was that one of them where we started out from?
That was one of them where you started from.
Yeah, so the other one looks like it spurs off from Kay Valley, which is my favourite spot on the line. Like we're approaching Norren Estuary platform, which looks like it's in between bloody tunnels again. I'm trying to set tracks here. Castle Bridge.
I'm interested because is there something similar to like Barmouth Bridge on an Orcart Estuary?
Railway to me, 7 miles away. Thank you, BR. Thanks a lot.
Last Norren Estuary. This. god. I can almost feel the bloody breeze and the salty water running along here. I mean, seriously, look at this bloody view.
This is basically as close as we're going to get to the Cambrian network as we're going to get, I think, Stephen.
Eject the disc. Oh, bollocks. Disc is out now on the floor.
I like that little girder bridge. I wonder where that's taken from.
I have no idea.
I think that might be from the Weird Ale.
Where's the TV remote? Oh, there's it, there it is. You say I'm lucky, but I would be if Northern knew what a timetable was.
I'm kind of like the Southern then. God. No rest for the wicked, is there? Holy shit.
Let me guess, you've spotted Barmouth Harbour. Yeah, that bridge was actually there.
Jesus.
Yeah,
that crossed over
Barmouth Harbour.
That is probably the longest bridge at that height I've ever bloody seen.
Oh, he's got homework to do.
Oh, homework.
Yeah, that's
Oh, that bush could be done with sort of bringing back a bit.
Yeah, that is indeed Barmouth Bridge on a Morcarth estuary. So, yep, welcome to Wales, Stephen.
Oh god, am I just about to suddenly hear from out of nowhere?
You would have been hearing it the entire time, Stephen, let's be honest.
That's all you hear in Aberdeen.
Oh, well, they do the same as well?
Yeah, well, the Aberdeen football fans, anyway.
Oh.
Who is pinging me now? If I didn't already know.
Oh, yeah, definitely on the Western region, because it's now at lower quadrant signals. This station's set a bit far away from the track. Yeah, this platform's set way too far back. Oh, that must be... Oh, yeah, I can just see the TPO on that board there.
Developer.
Yeah, it depends upon the developer really, who made it. Do like this. This particular type of sort of like bridge setup, they're sort of like the thick iron sort of like gird a bit here. I do like that on bridges. I wish I could have implemented that on some of my routes.
That's from Port Road.
They're in a large, it looks like, but a double track.
Die already.
A bit fun.
Zombie. Hey, cheeky shit. Did nobody tell you it was not nice to sneak up on people? Bellend.
This is Furling Sands.
This is the kitchen. This train is to the living room. Next stop, the hall.
Yeah, I do like this route because although it's detailed, it's not heavy on like insanely detailed sort of like 3D assets. So people with sort of like low specs could actually run this. And the J21's bloody pissing its nuts off. You were quiet nearly the entire time and now you decided to be loud as we're getting near the end.
Yes.
live injector on, that will show it up.
Where's the bloody zombie?
We're all getting close to the end. Well, I've got to keep myself in a sleep cycle. Yeah, fair enough. Got
well, he's in Aussie land. So.
Oh, Gold Art is Aussie.
Yeah.
Oi, oi, oi! The station.
Time to go link the teleporter.
I did nothing but teleport bread for 3 days.
Zombie got shot in the head.
You should have died.
He did.
I'm not quite sure about the grass still visible inside the station terminus, but
the way the ballast is the way the ground textures are being done, I don't know why it does that.
Because if we look underneath the platforms, it's still grass. If we stop. Oh yeah! As the Kool-Aid man would say. Says, oh, the platform's still relatively too far away. The platforms are set too far away from the actual track. But since we're in the terminus, let's actually have a mosey round. Ooh, another set of tracks down here. Let's see where they go. Where do these lead? So if we go this way. Oh.
Oh, that goes into the harbour.
Oh, this looks like a diesel depot just sitting here. Let's have a look. There's a. Ooh. Oh, I love all these old wooden sleepers that rusted the side. I don't like that. So there's a big old yard there. There's more tracks along here. Let's get a bit more of a bird's eye view on the situation. Ooh! Oh my god. They've spoiled it. Look at the company name that's on this lovely little lorry. Look at the company name.
Oh my god.
Instead of AEC, they go for DTG. Why?
Sell out.
God, this is disgusting. And I've just noticed it's got no headlights.
You could reskin it to say AEC instead if you want it.
Despite the fact it clearly shows AEC on the wheel hubs, look. It clearly says AEC on the bloody wheel hubs. And yet, but for the grill, they were bastards. But it has no headlights. It has no headlight clusters on it. No doors to the side either, for that matter. You can really tell that they really don't give two craps about making scenery in terms of like locos, not the locos, in terms of like lorries and trucks and cars, etc. All that well. They literally just make a block and go da da. Put no sort of like real like little effort into it. Yes, you can't drive them or anything like that, but it would still be nice to have some, you know, some actual detail on the bloody things. Oh, this is interesting. This looks like some sort of like
no
coal stage or something like that, considering the fact of how sort of like flat to the ground it is. Oh.
No, I think it'll be for the port.
Okay, so if we which way? Righty.
Every which way but loose.
Ah, this must be sort of like the, it's like a gas container sort of area. Yeah, because you see all the oil drums and the rest of it there. So that's for that. That's quite well done. And then if we go back this way and go down here. I can almost smell the sea air. This is a harbour and a half.
There were past ships, car ships, and ships. Cocaine shipping happens here. Some of it goes to the shops in the town, and the rest goes to the Fat Controller and Thomas.
NSP Productions, I have an idea. Next time before the next stream, you could make a poll on the Discord for what you're going to play next. Well, I tried to do one of those sort of like one of those web link things where you can sort of like make a poll thing on there, but I can't remember what bloody site to be used.
Straw poll.
Was it straw poll? Because I remember like Chris did it for his Cali Works one, but I couldn't remember what bloody site it was.
I do mine via straw poll.
Ah, right, okay.
Because I don't know what Chris uses for his. Oh, no, you don't.
Yeah, this is a bloody nice little route. I was about to say, oh, God. Look at the sheds here.
Yeah, those sheds are from the port road. Those are Dumfries.
That's Dumfries.
Mm.
Right, box. Please give me the Wunderwaffe. Gorgon, I'll take that, but I want a Wunderwaffe. Or an RPK. ICR, better than the Vesper, that's for sure.
Cold heart. Well, good night. Yeah, well, good night.
Guten Tag.
So yeah, that was the Norham Valley route on Steam. I was tempted to sort of like do another workshop route, but that would mean that the link for that wouldn't be in a description. So literally every time I'm going to do a different workshop route, I basically close the stream and then start another one. Literally just sort of like name them. Like workshop route explorer 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. I'll just do it that way. But yeah, that was a little jaunt along the Norham Valley route, which is on the workshop. Link to it is in the description of the video. Let's see how the stream has actually been going in terms of like the stream strength, etc. and the rest of it. Oh, not too bad. 23 people. That's not too bad.
Currently.
Let's see. Let's see what's been going on in the chat. We need to ask the most important question ever. How much are the trains here?
Eh?
What?
Excuse me?
How much are the trains in... Bah?
What?
English, please.
Could you please correct your English to know exactly what you're asking?
Yeah, I don't get what Simon is on about. Oh, do the branch lines. Well, I started off at one of the branch lines, but I didn't explore.
You didn't do on the K Valley branch.
I didn't do the K Valley branch. So I need to find a way of backing this engine up, uncoupling, turning the engine around, which is just there, then running round the coach in stock.
This is why you have a station pilot.
Where could I run round my coaches? I think I spot one. I think I spot an opportunity.
What, at the turntable?
No, if I set the train further back, there's a bit of a loop thing there. So I need somewhere to ditch my coaches, then run round or after I turn the engine. I'll tell you what, I'm gonna turn the bloody cursor on.
Bingo, I'll take that.
Bingo, ignore that question, it was being silly.
Bing, 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 bong.
Master saying, my ears. Despite the fact I haven't adjusted the volume level at all. It's just the echo effect they've put in the station.
Still a two shot killer this round, not bad.
Change that to a light engine.
Nicely.
am. Turntable doesn't want to move.
Oh, don't tell me he's doing it. Wait a minute. I hope the turntable's not done what I think it's done.
What, it's there but not there?
No. What it's, what it did on my route.
So I'm not be using that one.
I will investigate it. Oi, sod off. I'm trying to look at your pals doing there.
So it looks like we're gonna have to be running this one tender first.
No, I slap you. Bloody zombie.
into the platform.
Get your asses on board. Time to go and loot the last teleporter. And here come the poochies. Ooh, 3 points. Stumpy, bad Stumpy. Samantha, Wunderbath. Me. Well, I can hear me fine. got someone saying the loco is a little bit loud. Hey.
Yeah.
Someone saying the loco is a bit loud.
How's that? I turned it down to the 5%.
It's a pack of punch. Oh no, you don't.
This route is the Norran Valley route, which is on the Steam Workshop, and the link to it is in the description in the stream. Not in the live chat, but in the description of the live stream video. CML production. Which loco encounters are you using? I'm using the J21 from Victory Works, whilst the carriages is the GNR
Matrix Trains
GNR/NER non-corridor set,
which is on Steam. Give Carpenter zombies. I want the Carpenter. I want to board your windows. Leave me alone. Great, more pooches.
So should we head back along the until we get to that
K Valley Junction.
Back to K Valley Junction to go up the other branch, and that is this route pretty much covered. I believe we'll be going for maybe 3 hours and 20 minutes.
Just follows Bala Barmouth, I'm doing a modern revamp.
Think it was the Dub D's.
No, I think.
No, the S160s.
Yeah, I was gonna say it's probably FDR. Come on, give me the Wunderwaffe. Samantha, you bitch! I want Wunderwaffe, and you give me a rocket launcher. Why? Samantha, you're cool. Stop moving the box.
Is there anyone in the chat that was on the old server but hasn't got access to the new one? Is there anyone still yet to come in?
No, you don't. Bing, bing, bing. Which Discord? Because I was kicked out.
That one.
Well, which one? That's the question. There's a new one. Ah! Thank you, Samantha! How kind of you!
I've I've made a little new link, so going in the live chat now is a link to my Discord server for anyone that hasn't joined yet, or that was in the original one, but not in this one. But this one only lasts for half an hour, so at 2 o'clock, 2 p.m. GMT, that will expire.
Time to pack a punch.
How far away is... Oh, not too far. Not too far.
The Waffa DG3.
I thought he was about to say DTG then.
No, this will zap DTG. Bad Poochie.
Hey, Poochie, it looks like you have something to say.
Yes, it's I certainly do.
It's an undead doggo. It's an undead doggo.
Oh. Do you think you'll get derail value? Because when you buy it, it's it won't enable or will detect if you've got the if you don't have anything with VR for it.
Hmm.
Do you think you'll get derail value? Because they although it hasn't, eh?
I've got it.
You've got it.
Yeah.
Because I had a look at what they're sort of like they're up to, and although it says in the queue. They're going to be doing, and I think this is as far as they're ever going to get, which is unfortunate, but they're doing a two-player co-op with it, so it's not like we can have sort of like four or five of us in this session at once. It looks like it's only going to be the two of us, which I'm not quite sure why they're limiting it to only two.
You never know, things might change.
But you do need to get spin tyres. No, not spin tyres.
Snow runner.
Because I can have up to four people in multiplayer co-op. And me and Eddie, can't get enough of it.
As I've been seeing.
That there is no airsoft manufacturer.
Oh, there's, Captain Crutch.
Hunter.
Hmm.
Also known as my secondary drawing supplier.
Because I still remember the reaction that Hunter, the reaction you made when Hunter put in a set of drawings. He went, "Oh, you bastard, I'm having that."
I have reasons for that because, well, one was Russell. The Shay.
Oh, that was it. What was it? It was the Shay. You went, "Oh, you bastard!"
Yeah, and the other one was the Campbelltown and McCrahanish coaches.
Seeing as you say Campbelltown and McCrahanish, what is just out of curiosity, what's the latest from Digital Traction? Because it was doing like that weird looking sort of like. That 444 that someone else was
Someone else was doing that, and he's working on the B-17s, I think.
Well, DT's doing the B-17s, the footballs.
Possibly.
If they can get the rights to the names.
Well, I think there is a loophole for that one, Ben.
Yeah.
Release the football names as freeware.
Yeah.
Because why not?
Basically. Why is there no airsoft,
And who keeps pinging me? Oh, it's James.
Why is there no airsoft, maker that makes the Vietnam flash hider or in the bright orange needed for airsoft here in the US?
Because that's too specific.
Of course, I could just get one and then spray paint it orange so it's within regulation.
Yeah, but you're more likely to be seen.
Hmm?
If you go airsofting, you're more likely to be seen that way.
Yeah. Well, it's the orange muzzle brake taker front is required for US Airsoft.
Over here, it has to be 50% orange.
As your Thompson has
or
demonstrated.
Blue, or blue or green or whatever.
Yeah.
Well, we're going on the branch, Tom. We haven't explored yet. I've clicked on the link, but your server is not showing. Should bloody do. British Railway Studios.
Well, he's in. Right. Yeah, he is in.
Oh, yeah, I know who the fuck that is.
What, British Railway Studios?
Yeah.
The nickname, which says it in the read me first and the rules and that of this server, it still applies the same. It's just so that we know the names of the people that are actually behind, like the usernames on the channels, so we can actually refer to you by your actual name rather than, say, for example, oh, there's like Crutch, for example, instead of like Hunter.
There's this person. Or that boy.
Or Tiana, don't forget.
Here comes that boy, oh shit, watch out.
Oh, that's the old generic girder bridge. Oh, bless me.
Bless you. Bless you.
Looks like it's been reskinned a bit.
Slightly, yeah.
Oh god, this looks steep. Yeah, 1 in 72.
Zombie guy.
Ethan says right up the reading for the National Rally Team support coach before Scotland. Or pre Scotland. Go on, little J21. honestly, this engine has a beautiful little lovely beat at 25 miles an hour. It's bloody gorgeous. So actually, in response to, who was it? It was, I think it was, the Wild Simon's question. I think he was asked it, what was my favourite engine in TS? It probably has to be the J21, purely because of its sound set. Ideally, the Chuss, that is probably my favourite engine in TS, purely because of the sound set. Because I love running engines at heritage line speed, so i.e. 25 miles an hour. The J21 is one of the very few and rare engines that has a gorgeous, lovely and harmonious little beat at 25 miles an hour, because if you try and do the same with Bossman Games AF, it's god awful. It is absolutely dire.
Yeah, I'll tell you why, Steve, because that's just the sounds for it.
I'll say this,
and yet the Blackfires and Jubilees don't have that problem.
No.
Yeah, because this just didn't do the sounds for them.
Oh god, it steeps a little bit, the one in 49.
And the Manor's at 25 sound.
Starting
at
Jerome Regis.
Basically.
Release your stuff. Hey? Where do I release my stuff?
Like your reskins and things, I think he means that.
Oh, my reskins and that are basically private, because some of them I've had to modify the GEO files for, which under reskin law you're not allowed to release publicly, so they have to stay private. But in terms of
one thing he has released publicly are on his website.
Yeah, but which my site is bloody ancient. But in terms of like routes and that, none of them have made public yet.
Yet, being the keyword.
Speaking of which, your garden railway.
Oh, he was asking Ethan.
Oh. Yeah, Ethan's Peppercorn Workshop. He says, and then it gets worse. Why do you have three eyes? Greedy git, you only need two.
However, in terms of like release and stuff, although you asked Ethan where he releases his stuff, I do actually have one announcement tonight, which some people, you know, may be like happy about, some people may not even give two shits about, but coming soon, and it's only going to be made available on my Discord server for a limited time, and I mean a very limited time, but coming to my Discord server, I will be releasing, as it currently stands at the moment, because I'm still very much in beta, because I'm still not really happy with the assumption in terms of what I've seen around. But coming to my Discord server for a very limited time only to be made available, I will be releasing my Garden Railway model route.
In Brett Gage?
No, not in Brett Gage, because everything fits. Yeah, but for those of you that were asking about it in like videos from like years ago or anything like that, or have inquired about it recently or anything like that, my Garden Railway route, although it won't be made public on like a site somewhere, it will be made for a very limited time, for maybe for like the day or something like that. My Garden Railway route will be made available only on my Discord server.
And if anyone wants it, I can throw out Falmouth, the updated Falmouth.
Updated Falmouth?
Yeah. Changed the turntable, updated the track and the signals.
I'm surprised you haven't released it on the workshop, considering it doesn't sound like you've used third-party assets.
I can't.
Why?
Because if there's one asset I've used, it's not on Steam, and I've had to clone the turntable, and I've had to clone X of the King's Weird turntable just to make a modification to it. Because I've had to use the sort of outer thing to hide the hole for the turntable.
Yeah.
That comes with Chaddock Engineering's turntables.
Oh, yeah.
I've had to use that. And the X of the King's Weird turntable, I've cloned and added and changed the number of attachment points to 32. Because the way the turntable was at the moment, I could not use it. That's it, zombies. Come on and die!
This route mostly a slow one. No, this is one of the two branch lines on the route. The majority of the route is basically double track main line where you can get to like 50, 60 miles an hour on it.
Yeah, downhill.
What do you mean the main route?
Does he mean the main line?
That's what I said, the main line. You can get to like 50, 60 miles an hour on it, and it's mostly a flat with a 1 in 50 grade roughly about halfway along it.
Never mind, you answered.
Beautiful kiss up to the buffers. Put the engine in neutral. And that, after 3 hours and basically 45 minutes, that I will say is this route pretty much done. We've covered all of the main line. We started off at one of the branch lines and we finished off at the second branch line. So yeah, that was the Norman Valley route. Okay. which the link to it on the Steam Workshop is available down in the description below. I may do another workshop route stream in a few hours or something like that, not quite sure. Depends, one, how I'm feeling, two, how everybody else is feeling or anything like that, and
three, I need a piss.
Well, no, you can do that in your own time. And three, if if anybody else wants me to do another workshop route streaming in like a couple of hours or something like that, it all depends if people want me to do that. But yeah, this is it for the Norham Valley workshop route stream. I hope you all enjoyed it, and We shall see you in the next one, whenever that will be. So, yeah. That's that. So, ta-ra.